treatment of workers
in what is being touted as the biggest organized protest of Walmart in the company's history. More than 1,600 demonstrators were organized by Our Walmart. Supporters on Friday called for Walmart and its owners to raise the pay to a minimum of $15 per hour while providing more consistent full-time work. In Ohio, approximately 30 people showed up at the Evandale store to protest wages provided by Walmart owners. The protesters went into the Walmart shouting, but cooperated with police when they were asked to leave. No arrests were made Friday morning. In Washington, D.C., several protesters picketed outside the 8th Street location, which is walking distance from the Capitol building. The Our Walmart protests were met with the approval of the AFL-CIO. The nationwide protest on Black Friday came after a November 13th demonstration during which 23 employees were arrested in a Los Angeles area Walmart. Those arrests were of Walmart employees who took part in a sit-down protest.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports thousands of pro-democracy activists clashed with police in running scuffles in Hong Kong's gritty Mong Kok district early this morning in a bid to reclaim part of one of the city's largest and most volatile protest sites. After a tense standoff lasting hours, chaos erupted as hundreds of riot police baton-charged demonstrators with shields, pepper spraying, and wrestling a string of them to the ground. The clampdown only stoked more protest, and a three-hour march by hundreds of people calling for real full democracy helped put the city's 28,000 strong police force further on edge. Bands of roving protesters stalked the streets deep into the night amid a well of sirens, sometimes pelting police with eggs, bottled water, and wooden boards. Police, some bleeding, lashed out liberally with their batons to keep crowds back. The fresh tensions came as authorities have struggled for months to find a resolution to the most serious governance crisis in the former British colony since it returned to Chinese rule in 1997. Unrest has simmered for three straight nights since a swift and surprisingly smooth police clearance of Mong Kok's main protest encampment on Wednesday that resulted in over 100 arrests, including two student leaders. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Well, today was an historic occasion in Pennington.
That's right, Diane. The entire town turned out to honor Paul Webster, the area's one gay man, with Pennington's first ever Gay Pride Parade. Paul, a 33-year-old hardware store owner, was too shy to ask for a parade, but that didn't stop almost 2,000 residents from showing their support for his homosexuality. Mayor Sue Hallinan organized the parade and even chipped in some of her own money to pay for decorations.
Well, I was channel surfing one day, and I came across a program about the Gay Pride. Next time I went to the hardware store, I said, Paul, we're going to throw you a parade. And he just said, oh, please don't do that. I don't want that. I beg you. He just didn't want us to go to the trouble.
He doesn't want to ride on the penis float. He gets motion sickness, so we're going to have him hold the reins instead.
And Penningtonians have already decided on a fairy tale theme for next year's parade.
Oh, that'll be great.
And if Paul has a boyfriend, they can both be dressed up as kings.
Terrific idea.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the live Saturday edition of the program. We'll, of course, take your calls about anything you would like to discuss. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, Cleveland police shoot a 12-year-old boy just moments after rolling up on a scene, literally seconds after the car stops. This guy apparently had a BB gun on him. The young man did.
This is an airsoft gun. I mean, it's
airsoft.
Yeah, that's
different.
It's a little different.
A BB.
Yeah, airsoft guns, you actually attempt to shoot people with them,
as opposed to a BB, which could be somewhat dangerous.
Yeah, you don't want to shoot somebody with a BB gun. Right. That's going to hurt. They're going to want to really punch you out after you shoot them with a BB gun.
So we can talk about that. There's video that has been released in this instance, but it adds a little bit, I guess, rather than just having to trust the cops' stories. That said, though, there's not much that can be gleaned. We'll tell you more about it coming up here in a moment because it's a tough issue. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and we have Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Let's go there where Michael Dean is on the line. Michael Dean, the host of The Freedom Fiends. Hello, Michael.
Hey, I just wanted to call and clarify something inaccurate that was said on the show last night. Our friend Dave Ridley.
Well, I wasn't here, so it can't be blamed on me.
I'm going to explain it. It can be blamed on you.
Oh God!
Because it goes back to last week of you not checking Johnson.
Checking Johnson's. All right.
Yeah, because you're his keeper.
Right? Okay.
You tell him what to do.
Oh God! Is this the muzzle sweeping thing?
Well, here's the thing. Since you weren't here last night, and not everyone listening was listening last night.
I was also not here on the show in which Johnson and Mark were host. So I don't think I was.
But you caught the flack of it, because like what Mark says, I'm the libertarian NSA. I listen all the time.
Indeed.
Yeah, so our good friend and good journalist Dave Ridley called in and said, I heard Michael Dean call in last week, and he said that you should never talk to the mainstream media, and here's why you should talk to the mainstream media. That's based on a misunderstanding. Last week I called in, and I opened with a joke, and my joke was, if the mainstream media ever comes to you, you should run as fast as you can in the opposite direction. And then I laughed, and then I started to talk about, you know, the Chris Cantwell sweeping himself and downtown Keene in that video. And I was going to get around to why there are times you should talk to the mainstream media and how I don't think that the Colbert thing overall was a bad thing.
The Colbert Report is the Free Keene Squad. This is a little short that was done by the...
A couple weeks ago now.
Yeah, the Colbert Report on my friend Ian here and some of the Keeniacs, the people who live here in Keene and mm-hmm. do activism. And it made them look like first-rate fools.
Yeah, and... Ian thinks it was a good thing. Mark yeah. thinks it was a bad thing. I'm somewhere in the middle. I think overall it wasn't a terribly bad thing, but Cantwell's bad gun sweeping in it made it tend toward a bad thing. And
I tend to agree with that. The sweeping that you're describing was you were talking about the scene where they're interviewing him and he's kind of sitting down on some stairs and putting a revolver back in its holster, and it just sort of, you can see the hole on the front of the revolver where the bullet would come out, it seems to be pointing relatively close to the camera person. So,
Cantwell says there was not a camera person, but regardless, he's sweeping shops in people in downtown Keene and definitely sweeping himself horribly.
I'm pretty sure they had a cameraman there.
The sweeping term, for those that are not familiar with it, is the idea that you're pointing a loaded weapon at, or you're pointing a weapon.
Even if it's not loaded, right. You don't ever want to point a weapon at anything you're not willing to destroy. And so obviously accidents happen, but that's still not acceptable. I mean, it's poor weapons handling.
Well, you don't want to shoot bullets up in the air, but one of the safe places to point a rifle is up in the air, right?
No.
Well, no. I mean, you certainly don't want to...
Dirt ground is the safe place
best,
to point it.
Best, but I mean,
you don't want to
when
point
you see soldiers
and...
lined up in a row, they have their rifles pointing at the sky.
I wouldn't necessarily say the government is the best place to look for gun safety. I think we have to be better than that. And Johnson got it in this whole thing of, well, I've seen videos of cops doing gun training and they accidentally shoot the ground or somebody or their foot. And again, I think we need to be better than the government in our demonstrations of gun safety. That's not really the point of what I'm calling in about, though. Johnson, who's not a gun guy, who thinks that, you know, he said, well, the safety was on. No, those snub-nosed revolver doesn't have a safety. He's not a gun guy.
Mm-hmm.
And him defending Cantwell, well, not defending, saying I was making too big of a thing out of the gun handling in that video. We got into a big tiff about that, and it took up most of the episode. And I didn't get to conclude what I'd set the joke up of, which was, that I was making a joke when I said, run away as fast as possible.
From the mainstream media.
Right. And I was going to get to the conclusion. I make my living dealing with the mainstream media. I make my living dealing with corporate media. I was signed to Warner Brothers. I'm on commercial radio. I write books for the biggest textbook publisher in America. I licensed some footage to HBO recently. You know, I don't have problems dealing with the mainstream media. I like dealing it in situations where I have final edit, or at least mm-hmm. a good sense of the edit. But no, I don't tell people not to deal with the mainstream media. And it got hijacked by Johnson sounding like that congresswoman who said, oh, the muzzles, that's the shoulder thing that goes up. I mean, that's the level of knowledge he has of guns.
Okay, so what is it that you're correcting exactly? You were saying, do talk to the mainstream media?
I am correcting that I did not say to not talk to the mainstream media. Dave Ridley, anybody listening to that segment, now that I go back and hear it, could have believed I said never talk to the mainstream media. I've done like four shows since then where I analyze the whole thing and like talk about times you can talk, you should talk to the mainstream media. So yeah,
I say talk to the mainstream media. I mean, I think that you got to understand, of course, going into it, that they're going to butcher up whatever it is that you say, and you should keep that in mind when you're talking to them. That anything that comes out of your mouth can and will be used against you in a
lot. As it certainly was in your case.
A lot of cases. My case, which one?
The freaking
I wasn't actually featured in that, except for a brief excerpt.
You weren't featured in that because you sounded smart. That's why they didn't use
you. So you were audio taped and videotaped for it, and they were all cut out.
That's correct.
And one would assume then that that means that there was not the greatest opportunity to make you look like the fool that the rest of the people in it were made to look like.
Yeah. Well, on the continuum of Mark to Ian, Mark seems to be are you of the mind of don't talk to the mainstream media, Mark?
I am not of that opinion. Okay. I think that in this circumstance, that when the Colbert Report calls you and says, hey, we want to feature you on one of our reports, you should call your lawyer. And they'll, you know, like, this is a terrible idea. Like, they were made to look like fools, and anybody would have suggested that that would probably have been what happened. And I thought that was what was going to happen. It certainly did.
Yeah. And whether it's the Colbert Report or just the mainstream news media, there's going to be a particular viewpoint expressed. Whether or not they're supposed to be doing that is another question. You know, supposedly in journalism, you're supposed to present the different sides of the story.
Right.
But usually there's some sort of a viewpoint expressed, at least through the way the piece is edited and what they keep and what they leave out.
Right. And in this audio, Colbert and his team managed to make some of this this decade's, century's worst villains, meter maids, look like poor, beset upon heroes. I mean, it's amazing, and you guys gave them all the ammunition to do it.
Yeah, it was totally fun. It was a really good time putting this together. And there's
from every libertarian out there that wants to be a little bit more free. Thank you.
There are some people in the liberty movement who have made the statement that you shouldn't talk to the mainstream media, and I think that's just the dumbest thing you could
possibly
do. If
you're bad at it, you probably shouldn't.
I'm not one of those people, and that's what I'm calling to clarify about.
Okay. Anything else you want to add in here?
I mean, I would not go on Colbert Report. I would politely decline if they ever asked me, which I don't think they ever would. But going, you know, when Colbert was just a correspondent on The Daily Show, and The Daily Show does similar kind of mashups of reality as news, as comedy. Mm-hmm. I remember one time he was talking to Tucker Carlson, and Tucker was saying, you need to have more journalistic integrity. And this is back when Daily Show followed that show Crank Yanker, which was puppets making crank phone calls. Mm-hmm. And, you know, he said to Tucker Carlson, have you ever seen our show? It follows a show with puppets making crank calls, you know. And that's something to keep in mind with the Colbert Report. It's
thanks
the
for the call
deal.
Tonight, Michael yep. Dean. I appreciate that. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, Mark, I disagree with your assessment. I think that the Colbert Report also made the parking enforcer look bad because he claimed that he had as tough a time in downtown Keene, New Hampshire, as he did in Iraq.
Good job bringing back his PTSD.
Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time, call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm.
Yeah, we're going to the Texas Bitcoin Conference in March, and it's going to be a really great event. It's the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference, and this time it's the Moody Theater in downtown Austin. It's going to be loaded with the best and brightest of Bitcoin speakers and the latest exhibitions, as well as hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. Now, last year they did this, and it was amazing. They got, well, four ideas and companies sprung from the $1 million Bitcoin hackathon. That means that they're going to give a bunch of money to somebody who comes up with a really great Bitcoin idea. They've also invited the Texas legislature to show them how firsthand that not enacting complicated regulations, in fact, encourages innovation and job creation. Who'd have thunk it? The Texas Bitcoin Conference is going to prove that Bitcoin is a force for good. If you're knee-deep in Bitcoin or just interested, this is the place to be, March 28th and 29th. So it's a ways off. You can plan for it. You can use coupon code FREETALK. Talk Live to save $25 on your purchase. TexasBitcoinConference.com. You get your tickets and details there. TexasBitcoinConference.com.
All right. So we can still, coming up, talk about this 12-year-old shot to death by police in Cleveland. Your calls, of course, also about whatever's on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We had Michael Dean calling up, bringing up the Colbert Report that happened 2 weeks ago now with FreeKeen.com activists, myself, Garrett Ian, and James Cleveland, also including Chris Cantwell, who's not actually associated with FreeKeen.com, but Colbert Report pretended as though he was. Essentially, the Colbert Report was a work of fiction in a lot of ways.
Yes.
It's very fictive in a number of different ways. And I think a lot of people just, you know, believe everything they see on that show without really realizing it's comedy.
There's this funny little fact that The Daily Show is the number one source for news for people under the age of 35. And I have watched The Daily Show and The Colbert Report and enjoyed what I've seen and even, you know, thought that these were some, you know, pithy, insightful bits of commentary on modern American life, on the government. I think that there's some really good stuff there.
Yeah, but when they make fun of people you know, then indeed, you took it real personal.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. Well, like, there's a lot of that going on, but that doesn't mean that you give them the opportunity. Like, they're a bunch of socialists. Like, that's what they are.
Well, to me, they gave us the opportunity to have national exposure, and we took it, because otherwise we could have said no, and then we wouldn't have had national exposure. Let's go to Chris. He's in South Bend, Indiana. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Chris.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Chris, what's on your mind tonight?
Well, I was going to bring up an interesting point. Last Tuesday, the 25th, there was an interesting caller that called in from North Carolina, whose name was Robert, and you weren't there, and it was Mark. They kind of got into a little confrontation, and pretty interesting to listen to. It was like a 10-minute call, and I just wanted to bring up the fact that he is right when the United States is a corporation, and I wanted to tell you the actual U.S. code where people can actually look it up, look up the fact, and you just go to uscode.house.gov, and it's Title 28. Judiciary and Judicial Procedure is Title 28, Part 6, Chapter 176, Subchapter A.
You're losing everybody already. I mean, nobody's grabbing a pen and jotting all that down. Maybe you want to post all that information on
our Facebook. He's not claiming it doesn't say
Facebook.
It. He's just claiming that it's really difficult when you start citing these
things.
Start
reading
long.
Off numbers. You're losing audience when you do that. Look, did somebody on the show deny that the U.S. government was a corporation?
No, I just wanted to say, well, people think that sounds crazy, they can just go look it up, and it said the U.S. code says it. It doesn't even, like, step or dance around anything. It says the United States is a federal corporation. It says it. That's the sentence that it says.
But yeah.
Was someone on the show denying that?
No. What I in this circumstance, there was a guy that right. The United States government is a corporation. Just about every other government is a corporation. And municipal governments, these are all corporate bodies.
Right. There's municipal corporations.
Yeah, they're municipal corporations.
Called.
There's no doubt about that. I don't deny that. What I would claim is that what difference does it make if it is so? And other than sort of how can the government be against corporations when the government is a corporation, you know, the sort of lefty standpoint that we need the government to save us from corporations. Well, really, how exactly are you going to have a federal corporation save you from corporations? That's a really illogical statement. But other than that, it's like, what is the point of bringing up that the government's a corporation?
Yeah, what is the point, Chris?
What is it if it's not?
All right, I understand that question. I'll tell you. Because what he also said was that people themselves are corporations. And
right.
That is a fact. When people realize that and realize the government looks at them like that and not as a real human being, that's when people are going to really – I got mad when I figured that out, but it's just nobody knows. And
no, that's the one that you can't prove, right? That's a conspiracy theory to say that human beings are corporations.
Why do you think that – all legal documents have all your letters and your last
they
name.
Don't,
your
dude.
Name
they don't. Don't.
They just don't.
Sorry, I've heard this.
I
know they don't. Okay,
I've heard this and I've checked it out, and some do and some don't.
Right, that's what it comes down to.
There's no consistency as to whether or not they put your name in all capital letters.
Because here's a point to that, and this is really important. If you say that the only that the government documents always have your names all in caps. That means there's a whole bunch of government bureaucrats that are in on the conspiracy. And your conspiracy, I'll go for a conspiracy, but the more people you add to the conspiracy, the less likely I am to believe it. So that means that the local tax collector in my town understands that I am a corporate being and a flesh and blood human on the land, or whatever the terminology is somebody wishes to use. And I can assure you, she doesn't, because it's just not true.
She's compartmentalized. And you guys want to know a really fun fact? I know you don't, we don't sign checks very much often these days, but that line that you sign your name on is not a line. Go look at, go get That's a magnifying true. Glass and look at that.
Yeah, yep. I forget what it says. What does it say there?
It says something like endorsed signature. I haven't looked at it for a while, yep. but it says.
It doesn't say endorsed. Skull and Bones wants the yeah. blood of your corporate body to be burned in the pyre of the state.
But nobody knows that.
I know
though.
That,
yeah, but it could also just
so
be a micro.
What?
It could be a security feature, a micro printing security feature, that kind of thing. There might not be any kind of deviousness behind that. It is your signature, right?
Right. So, like many of these things exactly. that you've talked about are true, but then we come back to the statement where I say, "And so what?" Because it needs to – what the gentleman was claiming is that the rule is the world is ruled by three city-states, the city-states being Washington, D.C. as the sort of military power, London as the banking power, and the Vatican as the religious power, and that there's these flags that have three stars on them, and, this indicates
like
that.
Sounds like it's getting pretty deep already.
And you know, Washington's shaped however it's shaped.
The pentagram.
As a wheel-spoke thing yeah. to be able to tell you something. And, you know, right. there's a very big rabbit hole here, and –
Yep.
Will I agree that these are very important cities that, in fact, do rule the world to a large extent? Sure, I'll give you that. But do I think they get together and they decided to work together?
Right.
No,
does the government being a corporation make it somehow more egregious or less egregious when they violate people's rights? Chris, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-453 because what I'm concerned about is people who are peaceful being aggressed against by the state. I don't care what their organization type is. It's Free Talk Live.
The average family has 3 days of food in their pantry. Don't get caught with your pantry down this winter. Get 3 weeks of food free with your purchase of a 3-month supply of Go Foods now through November 30th. Call 800-648-9753 or order online at www.storefoodnow.com. That's 800-648-9753 or www.storefoodnow.com.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Free speech is protected on the internet, right? Not always. Government agencies try to limit free speech and commerce on the net. Luckily, when they do, the Institute for Justice is there to defend your First Amendment right to free speech. IJ helped set the first federal precedent for internet free speech in 1999. And ever since has worked to prevent unconstitutional roadblocks in cyberspace. Visit our website today at ij.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition of the program. Of course, you're invited to take control of the airwaves. Bring up anything that's on your mind. We still got the story about the 12-year-old boy shot to death by the police in, I think it was Cleveland. We can tell you more about the circumstances there and get your thoughts. Of course, you can also bring up anything. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE and join us via Skype at username lrn.fm.
You can get a free pound of coffee by going to coffee.freetalklive.com. This isn't just any old pound of coffee either. This is shade-grown, 100% organic. 1% top 1% grade Arabica beans. So this is delicious coffee, among the best coffee you've ever tasted in your life. It's BuzzBox Coffee, and we've teamed up with them to not just bring great tasting coffee to our listeners, because you go there, get the free pound. You pay for the shipping, but you'll get a free pound of coffee. It's a subscription, so you can cancel it at any time. If you continue to get your coffee through this subscription, A, you'll take care of that whole I need to get coffee problem, because it'll be delivered to you on a regular basis. You decide when, you decide exactly what kind of coffee you want and all that. But also, what BuzzBox does is they give us some of the proceeds back that we can then give out through Kiva.org. It's a microloan that we're able to give to people around the world. We've given many countries at this point people that are, and you know, sometimes it's to buy appliances so they can fix them and sell appliances to people, or you know, fix their car so that they can continue to do taxi rides, or buy restaurant equipment or sewing machines or plows or whatever it is that they need, maybe some more cows, to be able to live their life. And these little loans, they pay them back, and then we're able to loan them out to other people too. And I think this is a great way to drink the coffee you want, delicious coffee, upgrade your coffee drinking experience, and help people in the process. Give them a hand up, not a handout. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
Let's go to Dave. He's in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Dave.
Hey, gentlemen.
Hey, Dave.
Well, with regard to the call before last, I guess, or maybe it was last call, friends don't let friends go down the rabbit hole, right? You can waste your whole life deciding which conspiracy theory is the accurate one.
Mm.
What counts is action. You just take action. Every second that you're talking a conspiracy theory, you're not taking action.
Yeah, that's a great point.
There's a lot of studying that goes into this, you know, is the government keeping a big file of us and we're all corporate entities and that's how they manage to keep our bodies?
They're not acting on you, Mark. They're acting on your corporation,
all you
and
have
you
to
have
do,
to separate yourself.
All you have to do is stand up in court and say that you are not your capital letter name. You're a man on the land or a woman on the land or whatever it is.
It just does. In my experience, it hasn't worked. I'd love to be proven wrong. I would love that. I would love it for somebody who advocates one of these corporate conspiracy theories or courtroom conspiracies, these sort of magic words that can be uttered and that's somehow going to set you free. I'd love for someone to really show me the proof of the claim, because almost everybody who has ever called in
And first of all, most people who call in about this stuff, they've never actually tried to apply it. They've never actually taken these ideas and in any way, as you're saying, Dave,
but
taken
some people
action
have.
With them. Some people have.
And some of them have been successful.
And almost all of – well, that's just that you can't prove it. Because almost all of them who claim to have actually done these things and claim to have had success have no evidence that they have any success because they always have some claim that, oh, we can't get cameras into the courtroom or that you know, this all has to
be
done.
A free man on
the
land could bring a damn camera into a courtroom. I can tell you that. But the
I just want to see the proof.
I've seen some videos where some interesting things happen, but mm-hmm. you don't know what happens later.
Afterwards.
Is the judge just trying to get rid of some nut with a parking ticket? I don't know the answer. Mm-hmm. In many cases, you're just talking about sort of these, you know, odd little charges where you don't know whether they end up back in court later at another time. Who knows?
Dave?
Anyway, the action that I like to take when I'm not doing the Ridley Report is I like to call talk radio. And I started to get it down to a real science in New Hampshire. And I have a guide that I've published now. If you go to RidleyReport.com and poke around, you can find a guide to New Hampshire talk radio. It's like a calendar.
Now, is this only for New Hampshire, or is this apply to outside?
You can call from outside some of these shows. You have to be more circumspect if you're calling from out of state.
Oh, but what you're talking about, is this guide like a list of phone numbers, or is it like calling techniques on how to call talk radio? What are people going to see in this?
I'm not into giving too much advice on that.
I see.
It's just when and where and how to call.
Gotcha.
Most of these places have, you know, streaming and everything, so you can just listen to the show even if you're not in the same exact town. But I found that I'm getting up to about 6, 8, 10 calls a week that I'm able to get through, and I don't have to be on hold for more than a few minutes. And they're always talking about something that, you know, that Liberty is relevant, and you just call.
Yeah, I think a lot of people don't understand how easy it can be to call talk radio in some cases, especially if you're dealing with local talk shows.
National talk shows that aren't like the big three or four.
Even national talk shows, they'll never tell you.
Right. This
they'll
is the big dirty secret of talk radio. I mean, we rarely have an instance where you're a first-time caller that we don't recognize sits on hold for an hour. I mean,
yeah, sometimes Saturday nights are very, very busy and it can be very hard to get in, but most of our weekday shows, anybody who wants to call in, you're going to get on the air
in
short order.
If you don't hear a caller on the air on our weekday show, the chances are good there's not a caller on our weekday show.
Yeah, that's true.
And we're on dozens of radio stations across the United States.
That's true.
And that's just that. And I went on the Lionel Show, which was a nationally syndicated program. I used to call them on a regular basis. I wouldn't sit a segment on hold ever.
Dave,
I miss the days back when Free Keene used to organize those calling binges, you know, where a lot of different people would call the authoritarian radio shows and they just hated it.
Yeah, we used to do that a lot. And then the thing was at that time we were restreaming the local talk radio station, and they finally got there. The program director asked me to stop doing that. And so I did stop doing that, but now they have their own stream, and I think it's just a matter of people just aren't up. They're just not awake for it or not tuned in. Dave, thanks for the call. That's Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com. He does some great work here in New Hampshire. Of course, longtime listeners of the show know that we're here because of the Free State Project. Mark and I were both originally from Florida, in the Sarasota-Bradenton area. We moved up here in 2006. Dave Ridley actually moved a couple years before that, maybe 04 or maybe even 03. Dave's been here a long time in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project.
Oh, yeah.
He created sort of this one-man journalism, video journalism operation, poor man's video journalism or whatever, that he goes out and he records videos and he'll ambush politicians and he does some really great.
By ambush, you mean ambush audio recordings.
Right, not audio like video. Physical attacks. Yeah. Otherwise, he probably wouldn't be calling, or he'd be calling us from jail if he was physically attacking people. Yeah, ambushing is a style of interviewing. An ambush interview is where you haven't set anything up in advance. You just encounter the politician, whether by accident or on purpose. Usually it's on purpose. You go somewhere where you know they're going to be coming through. You know, if they're in a meeting, they're going to have to leave that meeting at some point, and you lurk outside with your video device and then begin recording. I've done a number of ambushes as well, being inspired by Dave. But anyway, he does some amazing stuff. And if you've been hearing us talk about the Free State Project on Free Talk Live, the idea of moving liberty-oriented people all to the same area, or as many of them as possible, to the same area to be more effective, to get active. Dave's a great example of what can be possible with just one person and a video camera. He's become the second most popular channel, news channel, I believe, in all of New Hampshire.
Behind WMUR.
Behind the main news provider, the mainstream media provider. Theirs is a little more popular than Dave's, I guess. But Dave's done an amazing work, and a lot of people discover the Free State Project and Free Talk Live through finding Dave Ridley at ridleyreport.com. So he does great work, and that's really cool. Great that another example of the spirit of doing that happens here in New Hampshire. Dave, you know, he's been calling talk radio, so he made a guide of what phone numbers to call and what hours the shows are on, and he's published that. And that's something that's a resource now that people who are also interested in New Hampshire can utilize that. Do you have that level of activism going on in your state?
No.
And if you don't have that level of activism going on in your state, because he's just one guy. We have over 1,600 people in New Hampshire.
Probably not
as Free State
as active as Dave Ridley, but dozens of them are.
Some of them are as active, just in different ways, in different media or different venues. So go to freestateproject.org, learn more about this amazing movement. That's freestateproject.org. We've got more Free Talk Live coming up. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can bring up anything.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it, but here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy and get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows, pause and rewind live TV, even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Hey, we've got Skype as well. You can Skype on in at Skype username lrn.fm. You just send a quick contact request. It will be approved once I notice it. And then after that, it'll be easy for you to call from that point forward. There's some disturbing news out of Cleveland, and Mark, you had the story. I've also pulled up a couple different versions of this about a 12-year-old young man who has been shot to death by the police. Apparently, the cops allegedly, one of the cops pulled the trigger within 1.5 to 2 seconds of rolling up in the police cruiser. Seems a little hasty, at least on its face, but there's some details to this story, and it gets a little bit confusing and messy and unfortunate and hard to really say what's the right thing to do. At least that's my impression so far. But Mark, did you want to tell us the story?
Yeah, well, I can certainly do it. It's about this young man named Tamir Rice. And I've got it here from photographyisnotacrime.com. 12-year-old Cleveland boy killed by police in seconds for toy gun. And I think seconds is an exaggeration. I think fractions of a second this kid was shot. But going on, the Cleveland Police Department is the latest law enforcement agency to come under scrutiny for killing an unarmed black person. However, Tamir Rice, 12, was carrying a toy gun that was confused for a real gun, even though police gave him no chance to explain it was fake. So he has one of these airsoft pistols. It is plastic. It is black. It looks for all the world like a gun. And it, the little orange thing on the tip of it has been removed. Right. Now, it didn't matter because the claim is that it was in his waistband. So the orange tip would not have been visible anyway, but it had been removed. And I've got to say, not a good move to remove the orange tip from your airsoft gun. Although I could say that it's interesting that police could just make the claim that one could put an orange tip on a gun in order to throw the police off their game for a second so that you could shoot them. Like, if my goal was to go and shoot cops with a handgun or even an AR-15, maybe I could throw them off their game by putting a little orange fluorescent orange tip on
it. I don't think that would work.
Okay, I'm just saying.
Because they just arrested a guy for pointing a banana at them. I forget what city it was, but we talked about it.
They arrested him. They didn't kill him.
That's only because they were a little more cautious.
Well, I don't know.
About pulling the trigger.
It sounds ridiculous to me once you arrest somebody for pulling a banana. I can see you, you know, grabbing them, detaining them, finding out it's a real fruit. I can see you taking the fruit and striking them in the head with it, perhaps repeatedly. But then let them out of the—
I was grateful they didn't shoot the guy. I figured they would have.
Well, there you go.
Because as the cops said in that story, they were scared and they thought that it was a gun. It could have been a gun, you know, a brightly yellow painted gun, which could be, that's possible. I've seen pink guns.
To me, there certainly are plastic toy guns. And I think that this
is
part—
pink real guns.
Right. Well, yes. But this is the thing is that I think that this story really does show the rabbit hole of what is a weapon and what isn't a weapon in America.
Whatever they think is a weapon to the police. And as long as the police think it's a weapon, it's a justified shooting.
Right. I mean,
it doesn't matter what's in your hand. It could be a cookie.
They can claim that you were making the gun, you were holding your index finger out. They thought it was a gun. It's a legit shoot.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So now this is a really difficult situation. Is this legit? It seems like if Tamir was menacing police officers with and other people, because according to the 911 call that came in, this is an amazing thing, is that quoting here, Rice can be seen in the footage videotaped in a park near Cleveland's Cuddle Recreation Center holding and pointing the replica gun, playing with snow and talking on his cell phone. The caller told dispatch, this is the person who reported him, that it was unclear if the weapon was real or not. It's probably fake, but you know what? It's scaring something out of me, the caller says. Not clear. He's pulling it out on his in and out of his pants, pointing it at people, but he's probably a juvenile, he added. The caller then left the area. Soon after that, the police dispatcher called the officer to the scene, but didn't mention, supposedly, according to the police, the 911 caller's suspicion that the gun might be fake. Mm-hmm. So dispatch essentially kills this kid, right, with out giving this information, because that would have been really important information to have on the ground. Also, the officer, when they call it in, claims that Tamir is 20. He looks like a 20-year-old black male. And I got to say that, you know, a 20-year-old running around pulling out a plastic gun, pointing at people, is sort of less acceptable to me than a 12-year-old doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, at what age is it acceptable to pull out a plastic gun and point it at people? Because I can tell you, I've seen children do it. And if you say, oh, yeah, well, the gun was fluorescent green, there are fluorescent green real guns out there.
Yeah.
So how many kids die because we have guns that kids play with? When I played with guns as a kid, these things were very realistic looking.
Oh, I agree. Yeah.
And they were as realistic as they could make them, cheaply, in plastic in Japan.
Thankfully, when I was doing it, we were playing in, you know, wooded areas where,
yeah,
you know, it was unlikely that anyone would make a phone call. This was in urban Cleveland.
Indeed. And so
this is such a strange story. And there's actually video, which isn't the best video. It's like maybe a couple frames a second. The frame rate's very, very poor. So you can't really get a good assertion for what's happening. You can see the young man, you can see the cops pull up. And the confusing part is that it looks like they blast him literally as the cops, the passenger side cop is getting out of the door, because it appears as though he just goes down.
As soon as
the car stops, that door opens and that kid goes down.
The claim is he was lifting his shirt as one would do to go for a gun. Now I think it's reasonable to assume that this kid was not going to pull his gun on these officers, considering it was a plastic toy gun.
I don't know. Well, that's just the thing, Mark. You don't know what somebody's motivations are. It definitely does. One of the things you can see in the video, and I'll link to it on our Facebook, Google+, Twitter. You can go to news.freetalklive.com to link to those. But you can watch this for yourself. It does appear as though he's got some sort of a white overshirt on. He's lifting. It appears like he lifts that up in the moment before the cop blasts him. But that's before the cop car even comes to a stop.
Now, I've got to say, I think a 12-year-old is a child. I don't think that you wouldn't trust them to have sex. You know, you wouldn't say that a 12-year-old could make a decision to have sex with an 18-year-old. So exactly how do we choose to look at this situation? Because I don't know the answer. If I was wandering around with a black plastic pistol, menacing people with it in a park, I would think that I would be, and then I go for it, I reach for it as the police officers come up, I would think it's a legit shoot if they kill me. Because as a 43-year-old, I shouldn't be running around with plastic guns.
Let's go to Mike. He's in northern Minnesota listening to WNMT. Hello, Mike.
How you doing, guys?
Hey, what's on your mind?
I just wanted to say that 12-year-old, it's a very, very sad, tragic accident. And when I did my job, I always told my wife, I don't care. And she would have to understand, but this is just me. If I came across a child with a gun, he'd either shoot me or I'd take the gun from him. I didn't have the conscience, and I don't. And I don't fault anybody. What happened in Ferguson was a terrible thing. But on the other hand, I bet not too many people heard about the 20-year-old white male in Utah that had his back to a black officer and turned his head with his headphones on, didn't hear what the officer said, and as he pulled his cell phone out, he was shot dead.
It certainly happens. And,
So you're saying you were an officer. You're saying you were an officer and you would not have been able to bring yourself to...
I was a security guard.
Okay.
I couldn't bring myself to shoot a child, and I told my wife that. I said, look, if it came to that point, he would either shoot me or I'd take the gun from him, but I couldn't live with myself shooting a child, and I don't fault anybody.
So you're saying that... So you're not faulting them, but you're saying you wouldn't have been so quick on the trigger.
Well...
No, not at all, and all the new guys that came in where I worked, I always told him that your gun is your absolute last. You only use that in desperate if you need it, because once you pull it, you can't change it.
This is an important part of this. The fact here is that people of different races are bad at telling the age of other people of other races, right? Like you and I, I'm just going to go out on a limb and say you're a white guy. You're probably reasonably good at, you know, picking how old a 12-year-old kid is. You probably get them within a couple of years. And so you're deciding at that point whether or not they're a kid. But this officer said, as he was calling this in, he called this a 20-year-old black male. So he's got the age way wrong.
Yeah.
And that's just normal. That's not evil. That's just normal.
Hey, Mike, thanks for your call, man.
I'm not saying it's evil.
Yeah.
And I'm not faulting him.
Yep.
But I couldn't bring myself to do that. And I'm not saying he's bad. I'm not saying he's wrong.
Could you shoot a 20-year-old with a gun? Could you shoot a 20-year-old with a gun?
Only if it was a last resort. If I could do anything else, I would.
Thanks, Mike, for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. And I guess the officer is going to argue this was a last resort because the kid looked like he was going for his gun. At least that's what they claimed. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, November 28th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,190, silver around $16.23, and Bitcoin's trading around $364.20. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat is presented by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. They've created a menu of food that's so good, so easy to make, you'll find yourself eating it every day, even though it has a shelf life of up to 25 years. eFoods Direct is offering 10% off to all Liberty Beat listeners. Just go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 and mention Liberty Beat for your savings today. In the news, a Harris County, Texas deputy constable in Houston has been charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon after firing his gun at a woman while driving through southwest Houston. Kenneth Kaplan was a deputy with Precinct 6. On November 11th, he allegedly pulled up next to a car, rolled his window down, and shot at the woman inside, with investigators saying the bullets grazed the woman's head. Kaplan was off duty at the time of the incident. He was arrested and taken into custody on Wednesday. Plans by the Department of Homeland Security and the Central Intelligence Agency to delete thousands of insignificant records have information activists up in arms. The National Archives and Records Administration had proposed deleting government records that lack administrative, legal, research, or other value. That would include records from the Department of Defense and Department of Justice, the CIA, and DHS. Some of the DHS records include files on the Einstein 3 network monitoring system, which contains a wealth of information, including metadata such as email and IP addresses. On Wednesday, seven United Nations human rights experts called on President Obama not to yield to pressure from the CIA to redact portions of the Senate Intelligence Committee report on CIA torture. The experts released an open letter to Obama stating that his decision will have far-reaching consequences for victims of human rights violations everywhere and for the credibility of the United States. The Liberty Beat, sponsored by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online, shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Consideration for the Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, November 28th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. Trappers in Saskatchewan, Canada, recently established a roadblock to keep oil companies from operating on their land. The Dene people of Dikarmi are Aboriginal First Nations in northern Canada and have a long history of trapping for a living. They say that way of life is now being interrupted by security gates and operations for mineral and oil exploration. Bobby Montgrand said the province's Let It Burn forest fire policy has also decimated wildlife and destroyed cabins, making it increasingly difficult to make a living in a culturally sustainable way. The police chief of the Houston, Texas Police Department has said he plans to put body cameras on all uniformed officers within 1 year. The cameras have already been worn by 100 HPD officers as part of a pilot program. Mayor Anise Parker has stated she supports the plan, but finding the funds will be an issue. Chief Charles McClellan says he believes they can put cameras on all 5,400 officers for around $7 million. The Liberty Beat is made possible by the support of Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? Well, the Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more details, just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, November 28th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
According to a study released Thursday by the Princeton University Department of Biology, this local 2-year-old woodland chipmunk has crafted a far more secure and dependable plan for the future than 8 out of 10 Americans. Reporters spoke to citizens to get their view on the study.
Clearly, this chipmunk is pretty impressive. I mean, he wakes up every morning and says, "I need to collect acorns and berries for the winter." sets goals for himself and he gets it done.
He has to make a burrow in a tree stump. That's exactly what he does. He doesn't pause and have a snack and lay around for a few hours.
Out of nearly 40 separate interviews with Americans, 33 told reporters they were very impressed by the chipmunk's continued display of foresight, personal responsibility, and pragmatic decision-making when considering his own future.
He's preparing for winter, he's building a home, and he's trying to get enough nutrients to make it throughout the rest of the day. All this while being worried about maybe getting eaten by a wolf or an owl or something. Earlier this week, the electricity went off in my home because I forgot to pay my bill. It's the second time this year.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into yet another hour of this live Saturday edition. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Young man, 12 years old, shot to death by the police in Cleveland. The police rolled up on a scene where he was ostensibly pointing a gun at passers-by or people in a park and somewhere in downtown Cleveland. And just as the police roll up, the young male walks towards the car, appears to be pulling up his shirt, ostensibly to reach for the gun that was stuffed in his pants. The officer...
But of course, this is a plastic airsoft gun, so it's unlikely that he's trying to pull a gun on the cops.
We don't know that, Mark.
We
don't know.
But the chances, I mean, you don't know what was said, right? Like, put that gun down! Get the gun! Gun, gun, gun!
I don't know if anything could have been said. The cops rolled up. It's a snowy day. One of the, when you look at the video footage, which, you know what, I didn't post it, Mark. I don't know if you did, but.
I didn't, know.
Okay, we will post it here over on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter when we get a chance. But when you look at the video footage, the cop, at least on the driver's side, definitely has his window up. So if anything's being yelled...
And it is winter in Cleveland.
It is winter. There's snow on the ground.
Well, I guess it's not winter, but it is darn cold in Cleveland.
It's cold enough that there's snow on the ground in Cleveland. And so I don't know if the other officer had his window down and was yelling anything. We can't tell for sure in the video. There's no audio track.
Security camera.
What we do know is that... As soon as this car comes to a stop, that door on the passenger side is opened, and it appears that the kid then doubles over and falls to the ground. I mean, the guy barely had a chance to even get out the door before blasting. I don't even know if he shot him through the open window, if the window was open.
And you can imagine how that would make your ears ring if you're in that car.
Yeah. So it's just a disturbing, confusing situation, and you'd have to think also in the young man's favor— How do you get to age 12 in urban Cleveland and not know that you should not point guns at the police, right? Like, you know, maybe you could say that maybe he was going to point the gun at the police because he was just playing because he knew it was a toy and, you know, whatever, it's just an airsoft gun and maybe he wasn't thinking clearly. But you would think that this guy has had enough interactions or at least has had family members who've had enough interactions with the police because to where he would be very cautious about dealing with the police because it's not uncommon for people in urban areas to know that the police are not their friends, that the police aren't there to play a game with you, that the police, you know, they're not there to help you.
Isn't cops and robbers.
That's why a lot of people in these areas will not even answer the door when the police come knocking. And that's, by the way, in my opinion, the right thing to do is not answer the door for the police. Because they're usually not there to help you. And these, you know, folks living in urban neighborhoods learned this a lot sooner than, you know, white folks living in privileged gated neighborhoods, for instance. So that's why I feel like he was not going to draw his gun, because he should know better by age 12. But, you know, we don't know. We don't know this kid. We don't know any of the details here. You're welcome to tell us what you think. You know, should the police have used more caution in this circumstance? Did they come in blasting unnecessarily, or did they really have a legitimate fear for their life? Was this kid going for a gun handle? The cops wouldn't have known it was a toy if he's just lifting up his shirt and reaching in for a gun tucked in his pants. Was it a completely justified shooting? So I'm going to put this video up on our social media. You can take a look at it. Let's go to your calls. We've got Matt. He's calling actually from federal prison in Marion, Illinois. Matt, you're on Free Talk Live.
Howdy, fellas.
Hey there.
My comment on this was, I'm not speaking about this particular shooting.
Right.
But it seems like what's been going on probably, you know, since the Adam 12 Mayberry days, is this evolution of the police trying to eliminate risk down to absolute zero. It's the shoot, you know, it's like taking no chances.
Shoot first, ask questions
right.
later.
Always make sure that you go home tonight. You know, never take a chance.
I think that's true. There is this officer safety thing that's supposedly paramount when officers are entering into a threatening or potentially threatening situation.
I'll question those in certain circumstances, but I say if somebody's reaching for a gun when dealing with officers that you know, at that point you're talking, you know, it's like a Tombstone. When you're reaching for a gun, that's a deadly threat in
my
opinion.
It's funny that you mentioned that.
I mean, I saw a statistic where it's lately we haven't had as many officer shootings since about that time in our history. But I think what it is, I'm not speaking about this particular shooting where there was the play gun involved, but just the police shooting more often, generally speaking. There's a for instance I can think of is I'm from Fresno, California area. They shot a guy wielding a knife in a wheelchair.
That's crazy.
Not only with their handguns, but with their AR-15s, and they justified it based on the fact that he had a weapon. And I'm, you know, like, what would Andy Mayberry do? Walk up and put his nightstick in the guy's spokes? You're going to go in a circle.
Yeah, I'm with you there.
You see what I mean?
No, I agree. And you know, we've had a guy on the show in the past, a former police trainer who quit his job because he was sick and tired of dealing with poor quality recruits. These young people who just want to be what he described as badge heavies. These are people who want to use the power that they have as a police officer to just wield that over people for their own personal advantage. And he was really disturbed by it, saying that one out of 10 of the recruits were actually a decent quality, and the other 9 out of 10 were a bunch of, you know, wannabe thugs and really bad news people. So it's just a disturbing trend of poorer and poorer quality police, it seems like, over time, or at least if, you know, the people who've been in for a while are to be believed.
I don't know about all that, but, I mean, when I was in the National Guard, we used to take the local SWAT teams from the neighboring counties to the Urban Assault School, and I'll never forget one of the SWAT team members from Fresno County. He'd never handled an M60, which is a belt-fed machine gun that fires every fifth round as a tracer, and all day long he kept saying, "We have to get one of these." I'm sure they have one now.
Wow.
But it was just like, this guy's clearly crazy.
Matt, thanks for your call tonight, man. I do appreciate hearing from you. Let's continue.
Well, it is fun to shoot those big guns. I can see why anybody would want to have them to be able to shoot them. I'd love to have a job where, you know, once a month we got to shoot some really fun automatic weapons. That'd be really awesome. But I don't have that job, and I'm not going to spend the kind of money it takes to go out there and, you know, shoot those things. But, you know, I mean, who wouldn't want that?
Bob is in Jackson, Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live. Bob, I think you're listening to WKHM. Go ahead. Do we have Bob in Jackson? Bob going once? Bob in Jackson going twice? Hey, I got you.
Hey, how you doing?
You're on the air. Doing great. Go ahead.
All right. Well, yeah, I just want to just add a little comment. I think the 12-year-old guy, like I don't know just how, you know, like how can you say that a 12-year-old boy looks 20 and like police are trained to like know, like, you know, just the weight, the height, the scale. You know, if it was a bank robber and they see him on camera, you know, the first thing they'll say, okay, he's a male, he's this, he's that, he's that. They're gonna point out all these significant, yeah. I'm in Jackson, Mississippi, and you know, hey, this is a high crime place. Matter of fact, I think we held the murder capital of the world like back in the '80s. Like,
congratulations,
I think I'm second to New Orleans. Or something like that. Well, no, not congratulations.
I'm just kidding.
It's bad, you know.
Yeah.
But the over point that I'm pointing at is, it's the same thing about the officer in person. Is what he said was he felt like a baby to Hulk Hogan or something like that. Like Mike Brown was like,
but he
Hulk
weighed the
Hogan.
Same thing.
He was a right, I understand that, but this is a trained officer. You know, I was once a military guy, and if I'd done something to somebody with my training from the military, I would actually be held accountable, and the sentence would be harsher upon me because I know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, the fact of that, I don't get, but I think it goes back to the author, Tim Wise, which says, hey, white privilege.
Well, I don't disagree with white privilege. I think it exists.
What we're going to be pointing to here.
I think that white privilege exists. I'm not going to claim that it doesn't. I don't know what people are supposed to do.
Well, no black privilege. I can tell you that right now.
Well, I think that there. Okay. I think that there are. There's black privilege.
Get shot then.
Well, hold on just a second.
Black privilege is getting shot. Well, right. We see this countless on every day.
It stinks comparative. But I would say that to say that there are places where you can go and feel comfortable where I can't go and feel comfortable is just sort of ignoring some stuff. I had a good friend of mine who's black. I'd go places with him, and sometimes I'd be like, hey, whoops, you know, like I'd feel out of place, and like I
is
might be in danger.
Is that what white privilege is that you?
You
don't,
know what? I think you watch the news too much.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you've got more, Bob, hang on, because I want to know more about this white privilege. I've heard about it. I'd like to know how it's defined. Let's get into that here. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
While getting drinks after work with a group of coworkers, local shipping clerk Russell Chambliss told reporters Wednesday night he was unsure whether he was bonding with his male associates or being mercilessly bullied by them.
Pretty sure that Bill called me limp dick earlier, and Todd keeps punching me in the shoulder. Pretty hard, too. I can't tell if it's their way of letting me feel like I'm part of the group or making me feel bad about myself.
Chambliss said while his coworkers verbally demeaned him and even made him feel physically threatened at various points in the evening, they did so with large smiles on their faces, making it extremely unclear if his coworkers enjoyed his company or wanted him to leave the bar.
Well, I told Jeff about this problem that I was having with my girlfriend, and he called me a pussy and then walked away. But then, like 5 minutes later, he came back with a beer that he had bought for me. What does that even mean? Apparently, I'm invited over to Todd's house for dinner this weekend. I guess that'll be fun.
For more on this story, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. The live Saturday edition continues here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and we got plenty of time for you with your calls and thoughts. You don't have to talk about the 12-year-old shot to death by police in Cleveland or police, you know, in general. That's not, you know, the only thing we talk about here. You can bring up whatever's on your mind. You can also join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And if you get online and you care about your privacy, you need to know about ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network. They encrypt your data online, meaning that your internet service provider, once you start using ProXPN, they'll no longer have any idea where you're going and what you're doing online. You can download the ProXPN app for free by going to proxpn.com/FTL. And just grab it for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices. Plus, you can get set up for Linux. Just the setup's a little bit different with Linux. And then get connected to ProXPN and no more prying and spying. Now, there's more because, yeah, you can get started for free. But when you upgrade to their premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can connect to. You can privately torrent and even get past regionally blocked websites. ProXPN is very handy. And when you use our discount code, you break the price down to about $5 a month. FTL50 is the discount code that gets you 50% off the price of the annual account. And that savings is locked in for the lifetime of your account. So go and get started at proxpn.com/FTL. Also, you can pay with Bitcoin for that annual account. You'll save even more. You'll get 62% off if you use code FTLBTC and then pay with Bitcoin for that annual plan. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Promo codes are FTL50 and FTLBTC. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's go back to your calls and thoughts here. I wanted to keep Bob on here for a moment in Jackson. Bob, you said you mentioned this white privilege thing, and Mark, you acknowledged that you think white privilege is a real thing.
Sure.
I'd just like to know from Bob first,
yep.
How is it defined? What is white privilege?
Okay. Well, basically, what I took from white privilege is basically the fact that, you know, after so many years of slavery and after 400 years and 100 years being free, you know, just the fact that your ancestors, not you personally, but your ancestors did certain things. Now, up until today, guess what? You have privileges because of that. You know, I stay in Jackson, Mississippi, but I don't know no white guy that don't have a job.
Well, there's plenty of people in trailer parks that there's plenty of white people in trailer parks with no job and collecting a welfare check. So this is why I am concerned. Like, I can understand where you're coming from. For instance, I agree that the man has been keeping black people down. I think that's absolutely true.
No, not the man. That's you know, that's metaphorically speaking when you say the man, quote unquote. That's metaphorically speaking. Not the man. Not the man per se.
Well, when I say the man, I mean the government, and I mean, you know, yeah, I mean the government mostly. And what I mean by that is that the laws, there are laws created by mostly white politicians who are, you know, they're essentially making it so that people, not just black people, but just poor people in general, but it certainly affects black people, I think, disproportionately because they, as you pointed out, started out from a point of slavery and have tried to, you know, climb up from that point. And these laws are created that keep sort of the bottom rungs kicked out of the ladder of affluence where, you know, you can't start your own home-based businesses in a lot of cities. You can't, you can't become an entrepreneur, so you're required to get a job if you want to have any income coming in. And of course, then you're just, you know, working for some white guy usually and, you know, putting more money in his pocket. So I think there's a lot of things about the way the system is set up that keeps poor people poor. And that means keeps a lot of black people poor as well. But I think it's more of a discrimination against poor people in America than it is anything else. Although I agree that there are racist cops as well.
Just so happens under this planet that we stay on, which is a flying spacecraft. So this planet that we stay on, which is a flying spacecraft, this is what it is because
it's flown by somebody
at all times. That's right. And the sun is shining down on us. Now, even though with all this known and all this technology, the only thing that you can even attempt to bring out of all this is that every president before Barack Obama had one thing in common.
Well, I don't know that that's of really any value.
They were all men.
To me, Barack Obama's election showed me.
I'm using that as a vehicle to drive my point home.
Yeah, but
man,
I don't, but I'd like to rebut the point. The point is,
okay,
is that there was some kind of glass ceiling in the presidency, but the fact that Obama won proves that there was no glass ceiling. If there was a glass ceiling, he couldn't have won. Now, the fact is Jesse Jackson didn't win, but maybe people just didn't like him. You know, Al Sharpton, yeah, he ran,
true.
But people
that's
just
true.
Didn't like him. Barack Obama,
this is why
I believe in white privilege, because Barack Obama could, white people could relate to him. He sounded like them, he dressed like them, and he, moved fluidly through groups of them.
So, also half white.
Well, he is half white. His mom was white. And so.
That's white privilege.
Right, that's what I'm pointing out, is that that is what white privilege is.
I'm agreeing.
Right, and so I'm not saying it's racist. I'm saying it's how people relate to each other. Because I think racism has to do with skin color. I think ethnocentrism, this is the term, or cultural bias, has to do with clothing and where you live and how you talk and all these other things that sort of confuse the situation. And the fact that this white officer couldn't tell that a 12-year-old was a...
White, well, hold on. Now, but hold on. Now, I want to say something in retrospect. Now, what you said, I agree with. But now, let's just take the Native Americans as a prime example to white privilege. Let's just take Native Americans as a prime example. Now, we all know this land wasn't discovered by Columbus. We all know that.
Right.
Because how can you discover something that already exists? Okay, so the Native Americans here. All right, the white European population, Caucasus Mountain, come down. That's where the name Caucasian comes from, because they supposedly in history migrated from the Caucasus Mountain. All right, so when they came down, they came over to the United States to form their own religion. But it just so happened, it's a catch-22 in there. To be able to form their own religion and be able to prevail like they had to, they had to kill off the native species of the land.
Well, no, they didn't.
We all know they destroyed it. But just because they destroyed the Native Americans with smallpox, lace blankets, and all these type of apparatus is used to just basically disintegrate and genocide a whole race. So you come in and take their land. Not only that, but then you make laws on native land and tell them to abide by them. Then you say, well, now, hold on. If y'all want to abide by these, we'll put you on reservations that's on your land. Not only that, since we started.
Oh, it's a tragedy. I mean, it's horrifying.
Right. But don't forget the final nail in the coffin.
About what we did, we're going to give you $10,000 a month.
Right, and that $10,000
a month. Never have to work a day in their life.
Well, they don't get individually. No. Wait, don't get under the impression that a Indian gets $10,000 a month. I mean, that may be to groups of them.
Well,
they get much less than that.
The head mother, but the money is being issued out.
Right, they're getting money.
I want to thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate the call. Thank you for making it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
And I think that's the most insidious part, is the free money. Because why do you think there's signs up in national parks that say don't feed the bears? The reason is because the bears become dependent on the handouts, and then they can't do bear things.
More likely to raid people's camps and come after people.
That's another good reason too. But people become dependent on the money, and then they can never go do something more.
But a bunch of sick tyrants coming over and slaughtering the Indians, I don't think is an example of white privilege. This is an example of people who are sick psychopaths.
I don't think that's a big. That's not white
privilege
in my mind
either. There's more coming
up
here. This is Free Talk Live.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, the Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service,
look,
and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, live Saturday edition. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
Do you have Bitcoin? Have you heard of Bitcoin? Do you have Bitcoin? Are you looking for a car? Because New Age Auto Sales is looking to be the Bitcoin auto dealer. Bitcoin is a new and emerging economy, and it's been difficult to buy certain things with Bitcoin, cars among them. With purchasing from newageautosales.com with Bitcoin, your money never needs to be exchanged into dollars to do this business. newageautosales.com, you can check them out for late model, well-maintained cars shipped anywhere in the world for Bitcoin. You can head on over to their website or give them a call and buy a car from the first Bitcoin auto dealership. NewAgeAutoSales.com. I think this is exciting. They're able to fill a niche, and that's really how you make a business work. NewAgeAutoSales.com. As a matter of fact, their cars all come from their rental fleet, and they're all late model, and they're well-maintained. And that way, you're not paying for auction fees and transport costs. It's NewAgeAutoSales.com.
Let's go to Danny in Virginia, listening to WNIS. Hey, Danny.
Hey, how you doing this evening?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Well, you know, I've been sitting here listening to your show, and you're talking about that 12-year-old boy who was killed in, I believe, Cleveland. I believe he was an African-American boy, wasn't he?
Yep, he was black.
Was, yes.
Okay, which has no factor in the whole thing. It's a shame that the young boy was killed. However, how many times have we heard about kids that are given guns illegally. How many times have we heard about kids that have these guns that are plastic, have the orange tips on them, and they take them off, or they've been torn off, and they accidentally shoot, get shot, because they go at somebody or they commit a crime with that gun?
Well, it wouldn't have mattered in this case because the young man was shot ostensibly when he had the gun in his waistband, was allegedly going for the gun at the time the police claimed that they shot him, or one of the officers claimed that they shot him, as I understand the story. So whether or not it had the orange tip on it would have been immaterial to the decision to shoot.
I haven't heard a story like that, but I bet that it's happened.
Well, you know, how much time does an officer have to make a decision whether or not he's going to shoot or not? You know, he was talking during one segment that, you know, the one gentleman said that he wouldn't have shot the boy.
Okay? That was a caller.
Was a security guard.
Yep.
Yes, that was a caller, and he said he wouldn't have shot the young boy, and he was a security guard. Okay? It's a decision that's got to be made, and it's got to be made in a split second.
That's correct.
For their life and your partner's life. And it's a shame the young boy died.
Okay, it is. I'm not necessarily indicting the police here. There's not enough information to really go on to say one way, for me to say one way or the other, who is right and who is wrong. I would critique them in suggesting that maybe they came on a little strong in this situation and sort of forced a scene that otherwise didn't have to happen. Like, what if the cops had approached from more of a distance? For instance, in this video, and again, I'm not an expert on what the best way to approach somebody with a gun is, but in this case, the cops literally roll the cruiser that they're in
into the park.
They're in the park. They're not on the street, and they could have just parked in the street and walked over. But they roll the cruiser up literally maybe 6 feet away from the young man in this video, and then pile out of the doors and what appears to be start shooting. So, you know, did they come on a little bit strong? Could they have come at it from a distance? And would that have given more time for them to better assess what was actually happening? I don't know. There's not much you can really glean from the video in this particular case.
Correct. And I haven't even seen the video.
Well, go to facebook.freetalklive.com. It is a current entry on our Facebook
page.
Yeah,
let me ask you this. When you were little, whatever the age that might be, did you play with guns?
Yes, I did.
Did you point them at people?
Yes, I did.
There you go. That's what was sort of happening in the circumstance.
Wait.
Yeah?
It was a long time ago.
Yeah.
Compared to what it is now.
Indeed.
And when I went to school and I got in a fight in school, I fought with my hands and I was a knife or a gun.
Okay. So are you claiming this kid fought with a knife at school?
No, I'm not. I'm just saying what I'm making a general comment in reference to what takes place now and when I went to school.
You're suggesting that things are more dangerous for kids these days.
I don't know that that's true, but the news would certainly have you believe that that's true.
Well, once upon a time, you could bring a gun to school, right?
Yeah, and kids got shot at schools back in the day, too.
Hey, Danny, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE.
Where I think race comes into this situation is the places where we don't think it's even there. Like, this is a situation where, what would it have been like if it was a white kid? And you don't know. It's really difficult to say, but I think that when you're dealing with the races coming in contact with each other, that it's difficult to sort of see, like you see a young black man with a gun, that's a different situation for a white person than a young white kid playing with a plastic gun. Like there's a different world that's created around it. Also, we have a situation here where this is the reality, is people of different races, black people are not that great at telling the age of white people. White people are not that great at telling the age of Asian people because this is just it. You're just not in contact. You just don't know. And is it good, bad, or indifferent? I don't know. It's just science. So in this circumstance, the officer thought that this kid was older. Does that make the officer a racist? No, it doesn't make him a racist. It just makes him making a mistake.
So I posted the video on our Facebook page with the question, is this police shooting legitimate? And Travis clips in response saying, unfortunately, this looks to be a good shoot. Officer should lose his job, though. Situation could have been handled in a different manner where it never came to the officer pulling the trigger. What if the cops, instead of rolling up what appears to be fairly quickly, like, you know, coming to a screeching halt almost, not that they would have screeched, there's snow on the ground, but it seems like a relatively fast roll up into this scene. What if they had slowly kind of cruised up, gotten on the PA system? I presume most cop cars have a PA system. You know, get on the PA system. Sir, please put your hands in the air. I mean, they had been called to, you know, been told that there was somebody pointing a gun at people in the park. This guy's the only kid in the park. It's not like they were rolling up on a scene of people who were playing with other kids. He's all by himself sitting at a picnic table. So it's not any question as to, is this the guy? This is probably the guy that is being called on.
Right.
So whether
they shouldn't have a problem shooting him before they figured it out.
Whether it's the guy or not the guy, if they know there's a guy who's been claimed to have been in the park, it's not unreasonable for them to, for officer safety's sake and other people's safety's sake, to say, put your hands up in the air. We're going to get out of the car and, you know, stand right where you are. And then,
or tell them to get on the ground or do whatever one's going to do.
Because in this case, I can't
imagine. Put the gun on the ground.
I can't imagine there was much dialogue that happened here.
No, there's no dialogue.
The cops pile out of the car and there's shots fired. I mean, it seems as though the kid hits the ground before this cop's even out the door in this video. So you can see it for yourself. Make your own determination. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. We go to Carl in Atlantic City. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Carl.
Okay. I just want an article in my Wednesday paper. Tar Sands Oil will come to Perth Amboy, New Jersey. It'll be oil from Canada, the oil from North Dakota, coming by railroad trains to New Jersey. And I find it ironic because my two U.S. senators voted against the Keystone XL pipeline. And I'm thinking, really? Is it because Warren Buffett owns the trains that this oil's coming to New Jersey? And I have no problem with that because I figure jobs for people in New Jersey. I'm not against it, but it's why not approve the pipeline and the same oil will go to Texas? I don't get it. Can you help me out?
Oh, I wouldn't prop. I have no clue.
Somebody didn't grease enough palms, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, I'm just of the opinion that all government programs have to do with back scratching, log rolling, palm greasing, and all the other things.
Yeah, there's no logic that goes into this. This is just political favoritism and corporate, you know, cronyism. I thank you, Carl, for the call.
I think the really difficult thing when it comes to when it comes to energy is. I don't know. I don't think solar deserves subsidies, but I don't think oil does either. And there's all kinds of tax breaks for oil exploration. Mm. I don't think the taxpayers should bear that.
I agree with that. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Whether you want to talk about the shooting of the 12-year-old in Cleveland, oil, or whatever's on your mind, it's Free Talk Live.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You haven't experienced yogurt until you've tried Amasi, embodying health and flavor in a true whole milk, green-fed dairy beverage. Every sip pays homage to our old-world cows and the ancient culturing methods their milk benefits from. With over 30 probiotics, Amasi's undeniably nutritious, refined, cultured sensation bolsters your health and awakens your passion for dairy. Amasi's so good, and you need to try it. Contact your Youngevity distributor or call 877-878-4203 or go to gcnteam.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Of course, you can bring up anything you want. We have been talking about police shooting a 12-year-old in Cleveland for ostensibly threatening them with a gun, or at least they thought they were going to be shot, perhaps. Whether or not that was a justified shooting. Also, the issue of white privilege has been raised by one of our callers. You're welcome to comment on any of those things or whatever happens to be on your mind. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and we've got Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Now, also want to remind you of a great way to help support Free Talk Live. You can shop with us. The way you do it, it's that time of year. Cyber Monday is coming up in a couple days, and of course, it's Black Friday weekend right now. There's lots of great sales online. You can go through Amazon at our website. You go to shop.freetalklive.com, and then there's three Amazon links. There's one for Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US. You just click into the right Amazon for you, and Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. It's that simple. You get the stuff you're looking for, the same amazing deals, the same Amazon Prime, the same free Super Saver shipping, all that. It's just that you're entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a cut. Go through shop.freetalklive.com when you're doing your holiday shopping or just shopping for you. That's shop.freetalklive.com. As we go back to the phones and the fun, we've got John in Madison, Wisconsin, listening to the Mike 92.1 WXXM. Hey, John.
How you doing?
Hey, welcome, sir. Doing great. Go ahead.
Yeah, the white privilege. I live with a black gentleman, and I also work with several black people. And I think the way we view it is that when a black person wakes up in the morning and they go out and look for jobs or try and get mortgages or rent places, they constantly have to ask, did I not get the mortgage because I'm black? Did I not
right.
get the rental because I'm black? Did I not get the job? Is somebody watching me at the department store because I'm black? White people get up in the morning and they never even have to think those things.
Yeah,
so
I've heard
it's really
I can't remember who it was. It was this lady who's like the only black CEO in America. She was telling a story about how she went to a party and essentially she came with her date who was also black. And essentially she was told, hey, you guys are supposed to go around back so that you can serve or something like that. Right.
Oh, God. Now,
well, that's funny. But wait a second. When I was at Home Depot, when I was younger, I used to go to Home Depot all the time. I was working on rental properties and things like that. Mm. I'd have people, usually women, come up to me all the time, especially if I had an orange shirt on, and ask me questions about the tools and stuff. Mm-hmm. Now, I never thought for a second this is making – I don't think that there's anything wrong with being a waiter, okay? And I don't think there's anything wrong with working at Home Depot. So I didn't think that there was anything wrong about this other than they just thought, hey, I'm a young guy and I could work here. And I certainly – I usually knew the answer to their questions and I'd help them.
Sure. Yeah, but that thing in a nutshell, we don't have to wake up every morning thinking those things, you know.
Generally not.
Okay. I think that's a good way to define it. I think that's an interesting way to really express that. Because just to say that they're discriminated, that people are discriminated against because of the color of their skin, well, people are discriminated against because of a lot of different reasons. But I think that the way you're putting it is very interesting. Thanks for sharing that, John. Yeah. Anything else you want to throw out there?
No, I think that's about it.
Appreciate it. Thanks for the call tonight. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
But the other side of that coin is when you have to guess every morning whether or not you didn't get the job or get whatever based on your, you know, were treated rudely in the checkout line because of the maybe because of the color of your skin, sometimes you're going to guess wrong. Mm-hmm. And it is, I think it's counterproductive to be guessing because you'll guess wrong sometimes. Like, I think that sadly, and I'm not claiming that this is fair, that's why I believe in white privilege, but sadly, the best thing to do is rise above. It's all you can do is rise above. Be generous in spirit to people who know less about race than you may experience on a day-to-day basis, and that's all you can do. Try to be gentle in dealing with people. We're all getting from one place to another, from birth to death, the best we can. Hopefully, we love each other on the way.
Rakia is on the line in Indianapolis, listening to WIBC. Hello, Rakia.
Hi, I am listening to your show, and I really like some of the topics that you're talking about. It seems really interesting.
Thank you.
And
go ahead.
Pretty much, I'm not going to ramble on. I'm just calling because I am an African-American woman, and just to add to what John had said earlier, I thought that was really, really accurate, you know, as far as white privilege is concerned.
What's accurate about it, and how do you see white privilege in your life?
Wake up in the morning as an African American, and say, for instance, you are not employed, you know, you do have to question, you know, do I have enough credentials to get the job? You know, as African Americans, I know you say rise above, and that's what we do, you know, from all athletics and so forth, from that into unemployment. We feel as though we can't just be average. We have to be above average because in this world, what we live in, we are always judged. And when you wake up in the morning and you feel like you're being judged from everything from what you put on your resume to your name, like Rakia is a very odd name.
Yep.
So
I guessed your color based on your name.
You know, and you have to question, you know, sometimes I abbreviate it because I think, you know, maybe that would get me a job better because of my name. And that's something that white privilege, you know, I'm, you know, that's my name and I'm glad of it. But that's something that a lot of people who are not not African-American, you know, possibly any other race, you know, has to face, you know. In addition to that, there's, you know, everything from walking down the street, you know, you have to smile and make sure you at least grab another person's attention and eye contact because you want them to know, listen, I got money in my pocket. I don't want to rob you. You know, I could fully function and take care of myself, but you don't know what the next person is thinking.
Yep.
You know, we all don't know each other on a regular basis. And until we get to know somebody, that's when you kind of can let down your guard because you say, oh, this person's a great person, whatnot. But as an African-American, you wake up in the morning and you do have to question, you know, everything from,
nope.
you know, Hello?
The reason, yeah, it's interesting. The reason you're doing that is because you have been discriminated against, right? Because if you'd gone through your whole life and had not been, you know, felt as though somebody had treated you differently or had actual mm-hmm. evidence that you were treated differently because of the color of your skin, then you wouldn't be mm-hmm. questioning these things. So it has happened to you in your lifetime more than once, presumably often enough to make you do this. Mm-hmm. That, I mean, how often has this happened to you?
Every day I'm alive.
Every
you know,
day.
You have to question every day.
Well, you have to question.
But
that's the thing is you don't. A lot of this, you know, there's the obvious and glaring instances, and the rest is sort of it exists in the periphery of your vision. It just kind of it's like somebody waving their hands by your ears. You really can't tell.
You know what? I can totally understand what you're talking about with the peripheral of your vision. You know, because me as an addition, you know, my hair is not really long and wavy. You know, I don't have any relaxer conditions. My hair is natural in its natural state, you know. So therefore, you know, I have to be very confident within myself to actually be able to set myself apart from, you know, just, you know, the stereotype of, you know, I have to look, you know, relaxed, you know, so other people will, you know, rely on me to feel comfortable. Mm. I have to, my smile, my attitude, my positiveness, all that comes forth, you know, and exemplifies who I am as an individual.
Yeah, so, there's a know, lot of, yes, there's this subtext. There's the subtext
but
that many whites don't know. Go ahead.
I did want to say something about, you know, the child, you know, and I have to let my kids, and I have a son and a daughter, you know, who are African American, and I do have to let them know, you know, regardless of the neighborhood you live in, which we live in a really nice neighborhood, you know, majority of the people that we live in, you know, are, you know, of, you know, Caucasian descent, you know, we still have to remind, I still have to remind my kids, you know, hey, you are a black kid, you know, that, you know, it could easily be my son, you know, in the park, just like that little boy. And like I said, you know, if I tell my son, you know, if you see a police officer, you see a police car, you immediately raise your hand, you know, you don't look in your arms. My son has asthma.
Yeah, these aren't conversations white people have with their kids.
No,
these are not conversations white people have with their kids.
Which is why I'm shocked that this 12-year-old actually, you know, allegedly raised his shirt as though he was going for the gun.
You know what? Little boys, I think, really like him, and for whatever reason, I don't know why he had that. He might have just been like Trayvon Martin, new to the area, not knowing, walking down the street, he went to the store, got something to drink, not knowing that some guy was looking at him, thinking he was, some kind of person who didn't belong there. This kid, who knows what he was, it's the holiday weekend, whatever. You know,
yeah,
who
he
knows
was, yeah, I think he must have been
child,
completely
you know?
Oblivious, which
been
is
handicapped.
It's why
he
it's such a surprise to me.
But when the police officer, and I haven't seen your video, but to me, I am too broken up to see the video right now. I can't do it. Some things are just too much for me. That would be a video that would be too much for me, especially if I'm knowing what you've said, and I've heard that the police officer rolled up on this child 6 feet away and literally did not, you know, I spoke to a young man who was Caucasian, he was a teenager, and he said him and his dad go hunting, you know. That's something that as a black person, if we wanted to do, you know, we'd have to think twice about. You know, if you know, I'm not saying it's a bad thing or not. You know, people do it all the time. But
Rekia, I
want to
thank you for your call and the thoughts tonight. Thank you so much.
Sorry,
I do appreciate it. There's more coming up here in moments. 855 450 free. We've got plenty of time to get you with your thoughts on the air. This is Free Talk Live.
You've heard of Black Friday doorbuster deals. Well, don't miss Lumber Liquidators Floorbuster Deals. Get incredible discounts on your favorite floors at one-time only prices. There's never been a better time to get a great deal on pre-finished hardwoods, hand-scraped hardwoods, gorgeous bamboo, top-quality laminates, and get 26-month special financing. Plus, get even more floorbuster discounts in our stores. The sale ends Tuesday. These deals will not wait until after the holidays. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBucks to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you
want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too. Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Canaan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, November 29th, 2014. Silver is trading at $15.47 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,167 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $383. Antiwar.com reports Syrian airstrikes against the capital city of Raqqa, the Islamic State, this week ended up killing scores of civilians, 95 of them by some accounts, and has fueled a round of U.S. condemnations accusing them of deliberately targeting residential areas. Syria denied the accusation, saying the death tolls were fabricated and that they were being far more careful about civilian casualties than, say, the nations that are arming rebel factions in the country. Syrian officials went on to accuse the U.S. of ignoring the number of civilians killed by the Islamic State, which is a number far greater than those alleged to have happened in this round of airstrikes. Reports of large civilian tolls are nothing new, but it is noteworthy that the Assad government is using the exact same tactics the Pentagon is using in reports of its own civilian deaths in U.S. strikes against the exact same territory. The strategy is to deny the deaths and to follow that up by accusing the enemy they're attacking of being way worse at any rate.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com.
USA Today reports some Walmart shoppers looking for doorbuster deals on Black Friday were met by protesters speaking out against the retailer's treatment of workers. In what is being touted as the biggest organized protest of Walmart in the company's history, more than 1,600 demonstrators were organized by Our Walmart. Supporters on Friday called for Walmart and its owners to raise the pay to a minimum of $15 per hour while providing more consistent full-time work. In Ohio, approximately 30 people showed up at the Evandale store to protest wages provided by Walmart owners. The protesters went into the Walmart shouting, but cooperated with police when they were asked to leave. No arrests were made Friday morning. In Washington, D.C., several protesters picketed outside the H Street location, which is walking distance from the Capitol building. The Our Walmart protests were met with the approval of the AFL-CIO. The nationwide protest on Black Friday came after a November 13th demonstration during which 23 employees were arrested in a Los Angeles area Walmart. Those arrests were of Walmart employees who took part in a sit-down protest.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports thousands of pro-democracy activists clashed with police in running scuffles in Hong Kong's gritty Mong Kok district early this morning in a bid to reclaim part of one of the city's largest and most volatile protest sites. After a tense standoff lasting hours, chaos erupted as hundreds of riot police baton-charged demonstrators with shields, pepper spraying, and wrestling a string of them to the ground. The clampdown only stoked more protest, and a three-hour march by hundreds of people calling for real full democracy helped put the city's 28,000-strong police force further on edge. Bands of roving protesters stalked the streets deep into the night amid a well of sirens, sometimes pelting police with eggs, bottled water, and wooden boards. Police, some bleeding, lashed out liberally with their batons to keep crowds back. The fresh tensions came as authorities have struggled for months to find a resolution to the most serious governance crisis in the former British colony since it returned to Chinese rule in 1997. Unrest has simmered for three straight nights since a swift and surprisingly smooth police clearance of Mong Kok's main protest encampment on Wednesday that resulted in over 100 arrests, including two student leaders. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
From that romantic summer evening in 1924 when Pol Pot was conceived, to the first time someone figured out how to eat a pineapple without ripping their mouth to shreds, this week in history. 1692, five citizens were executed after being convicted during the Salem witch trials. All while dozens of witches, warlocks, and sorcerers stood by and watched the wrongly accused take the rap for them, while a perfectly normal humans charged with witchcraft were publicly hung and dragged to their unmarked graves, the numerous Salem citizens that did spend their evenings casting spells and awakening the dead merely lowered their heads as their friends and neighbors were burned at the stake.
Historical records have indicated that as many as 35% of the people in Salem were actually witches and warlocks. In fact, the executioner himself was a well-known necromancer who, after hanging the wrongly accused witches, reanimated their dead bodies and apologized before casting them into the eternal fires of hell.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm with you in the studio tonight. You've got Ian with you.
And Mark.
And we're going to get right back into your calls. But to bring you up to speed, in case you're just tuning in, the story of note tonight that we that Mark, you actually brought into the table is of a 12-year-old male in Cleveland who was shot to death by the police after someone called the police on him for ostensibly having a gun in a public park, allegedly pointing the gun at people. Gun turned out to be an airsoft pistol or rifle. I guess it was a pistol because it was in his...
It looked like a 1911.
It was apparently in his waistband. They sell these guns with the orange caps on the front of the gun, but he has somebody allegedly removed the cap from this gun.
Not that it mattered since it was in his waistband.
Right. And the story from the police, and it seems to be corroborated by a fairly crappy surveillance camera video, is that this young male was in the park, the police rolled up, and they claim they told him to, what was it they told him? They yelled something at him, right?
Well, the claim was is that they told him to put his hands in the air or something like that, but like three times before they shot, there's no way.
I don't believe that. Just based on the amount of time that transpires between the police rolling up in the cruiser, hopping out, and this guy falls to the ground as soon as the doors... The guy in the driver's side doesn't even have his door open before this kid's on the ground. And it's, you know, again, the video is not great quality. We did post it on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter. You can access all of those by going to news.freetalklive.com to get to your favorite social media page where we're at. And you can judge for yourself, you know, if he's going for the gun, as the police claim, the claim that he, you know, went for the gun in his waistband and that's when they shot him. If that's what actually happened, then it's hard to really say that the police were unjustified in shooting him because, well, you know, if somebody's going for a gun in their waistband, it's not an unreasonable presumption to think that they're going for the gun to shoot you with.
Right. Maybe they're not going to reach down, get the gun, and drop it on the ground.
So we've had this discussion going on. You know, did the police do this the right way? I think they could have approached it more cautiously rather than the sort of rolling right up 5 feet away from the kid as in a very fast, kind of intimidating manner. Maybe they could have taken it a little slower,
and with
on
everything,
the PA system.
And right now, with Ferguson having gone on, just about everything's colored by race.
And he was a black young male, and the cops were white. So that also led to a discussion about this white privilege. So that's where we've been so far tonight. You can also bring up anything that happens to be on your mind. Let's go to Bruce. He is in Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Bruce.
Hey, buddy, how's it going tonight?
Man. You're on the air. Going great. Go ahead.
I kind of want to hit on all the points, but I have a little bit of a story kind of to go along with it. My brother-in-law, first thing I'm going to tell you about is my brother-in-law. He's a concrete man. He finishes concrete, and he's white. But he has to go through the same thing every time he fills out a job application. Did I not get the job because I'm not black? And the reason being behind that is in the industry that he is in, concrete finishing, It is a predominantly black industry.
Interesting.
So the door swings both ways.
Yeah. Well, there's also situations with government contracts where minority businesses...
where they have to have people.
Yep. Minority businesses get preference, and it's easier, that kind of thing. So, I mean, there's...
That's not the same as what was being described, though. I mean, it's an aspect of it.
And I kind of understand that, but it's in the same aspect. I mean, where I grew up, I have to go through the same thing every day because I'm in a black community, and I am the white guy in the black community. But basically, what the white people in my community feel is kind of the same type of pressures and stuff that the people in a more white community that are of any kind of descent, whether it be black, Mexican, or whatever, I'm sure they feel the same pressures. But it really has to depend on geographically. And stuff like that, because, like I said, where I'm at, I mean, it doesn't happen to me. I have my own business, so I get screwed by everybody.
Right.
But my wife, same type of thing. She's had many a job where they've told her, we can't give you the job right now because we have to hire more black people. Have actually come out and told her that.
Yeah, but okay. So I understand what you're saying when it comes to hiring quotas, maybe that are mandated by governments. That's one thing that you have to deal with. But the last caller that we had prior to you in the last hour, she expressed that it's a daily thing where she's getting up in the morning and she thinks about these things. You know, am I being discriminated against? Whether it's in a line at the store.
But it's only paranoia when you're wrong.
But wait a minute. What she's basing that on is that when she was growing up, there were experiences she had that made it pretty clear that she was being discriminated against.
She probably has experiences every day, every year that are like that.
Yeah, I would think so. So I guess that's my question for you. Are you saying that you feel as though, if you're living in this black neighborhood or this black town or whatever, and you're one of the only few white people there, is it just because you're different is why you're feeling that way, or because you actually have specific instances where you know you've been discriminated against, not because of some government rule, but simply because somebody has a bias against you because you're white?
Both, truthfully. Both.
Give me one example.
One example, I got arrested just not too long ago. I'm a contractor, and I had some of my items stolen from my home. Matter of fact, it was all over the news where we live because I'm a contractor, and the people that stole it from me was actually one of the painters that I had working for me. Mm-hmm. And I found out him and his girlfriend were homeless, and I let him come stay with me. Mm. First mistake right there, letting a homeless person stay with me. That'll never happen again. I might help them do whatever I can from whatever, but they're never going to come in my home again because they stole $40,000 worth of equipment from
me. Jeez.
Wow.
Now, I seen some of my equipment in a neighboring town, which is another one of the instances, like I'm saying, predominantly black community. I call the police. The police come out and talk to these individuals. Now, I'm a white guy. The police are black, and the individuals with my stuff are black. The police talk to those individuals. The individuals blatantly lied while I was on the phone trying to get in touch with the other police precinct from the other town to get the report number and all of the stuff so this officer could have something to go by. While I'm on the phone waiting, I see this officer start shaking that man's hand that has my stolen items.
Ruh-roh.
And I say, please, sir,
and I'm not going to cuss because we're on the radio, but mm-hmm. please, sir, don't let him steal my S again. Please, sir, do your job. Don't let him steal my S again. That's how I feed my family.
Wait a second. So this and is the guy with the stuff is not the guy who stole it. It's somebody who has it, right?
I have no clue.
Well, you would know who stole it because you said you let them stay with you.
The gentleman that was with this guy that stole the stuff from my house, I never had met him.
I see.
They caught them both together in the end.
Okay.
But this gentleman that had my stuff from the other person that physically stole it, a partner of his, a buddy of his, and I didn't know that at the time, no. But what I did feel and see at the time was a black police officer listening to what the black man said, ignoring what I said, and when I said, please don't let him steal my S again, please do your job, don't let him steal my S again, that's how I feed my family. The officer turned around and arrested me for disorderly conduct.
Wow.
And I called the police to get my stolen stuff back. So, yes, I do. I have had instances where it's real and it has happened.
Interesting.
But with that, that's enough of that subject. The next one was the kid being shot.
Yeah.
All right. In Virginia Beach, close to my where I live, is maybe 45-minute drive. When I was like 19 or 20, I'm 36 now. When I was like 19 or 20, I remember they threw a really big deal because there was a guy in a Rite Aid grocery or Rite Aid pharmacy that was in there acting weird. The police came because it was just a suspicious person, suspicious activities. The police came. They tried to get the man to listen to him. He was being, belligerent and not listening to him. They drew down on him with a gun, told him that he needed to get on the ground and listen to him because they didn't know what he was going to do. The man went to go reach real fast in his pocket. When he went to reach in his pocket, he grabbed something in his pocket, and on the way of pulling it out, the police officers there shot him and killed him.
Yep.
What he pulled out of his pocket, and this is no lie, was a banana.
Thanks for the call tonight, Bruce. Appreciate the story. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. So Bruce is saying the door swings both ways on this privilege thing.
I think it's true.
It's Free Talk Live.
Inventory isn't about products, kid. It's about money. Products sitting on shelves is money sitting on shelves. I hate overstock. I hate understock. I hate wasting time. I hate wasting money. That's why I love Grainger. Grainger KeepStock solutions help us manage our facility's inventory so we have exactly what we need when we need it. No more, no less. It's inventory management my way. Get it? Got it? Good. Visit Grainger.com/KeepStock for more information. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. Treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world.
So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in and bring up anything that's on your mind. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Whether it be police shootings, white privilege, these are some of the topics we've discussed here tonight, but not all of them. You can also take control of the airwaves here. That's why we call the show Free Talk Live. And we've got some websites we recommend.
Yeah, AndyWar.com is one of them. This is a really unusual website because there aren't that many websites that take a look at the news and the news from around the world from the standpoint of a foreign policy that's non-interventionist. Now, that's for every country, but since the United States is doing a lot of intervening, it tends to be the United States that they're writing the stories about. And they have an incredible amount of readers, and they used to have an incredible amount of donors until the FBI decided to start poking around and sort of letting their donors know, hey, we're keeping an eye on you since you're a donor to AntiWar.com. Kind of scared them all away. So AntiWar.com, go check it out. Read some stories. See what they have to say. If you like it, you should consider donating. If you are a longtime reader of AntiWar.com, consider that news source that has all those readers, they're only kept afloat by donations. It's antiwar.com/donate. And yes, if you're worried about the FBI looking in, you can use Bitcoin. Use the anonymous internet currency, Bitcoin, to donate. They love it there. antiwar.com/donate. Because war is the health of the state.
All right, let's go right into your phone calls and thoughts. Judy is on the line in Pennsylvania. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Judy.
Hi, how are you guys?
Hey, great. What's on your mind tonight?
A couple quick comments, and now I don't even know where to start. I guess I'm an older person, older than you guys, and it's so sad to see things coming back around to this whole racial crap. Like, a little bit earlier you said that the door swings both ways. Well, it can swing many ways. Like, what about fat people?
Yep.
Fat people wake up in the morning fat, and they think, oh, I didn't get that job because I'm fat, you know. So it's all, like, inside is where things are coming from.
Mm.
And as I said, it's so sad to see the whole racial thing coming back.
Well, wait. When you say inside is where it's coming from, it's coming from inside because you've had experiences coming from outside, right? Like, people have discriminated against someone because they're fat or because they're black or white.
Well, how does one really know?
You don't always know.
You don't always know, but you've been – sometimes you could –
But if you ask a guy out on a date and he says, no, thank you, you're fat, then you know that at the very least, in that way – in that one way, you've been discriminated against.
Well, or that, or maybe he didn't like my color of hair.
No, he could say, no, thanks, you're fat. And then you know that you could assume that he's either telling the truth or lying.
Yeah. Well, in that case, yes. But what I'm saying is that in speaking about, you know, if you wake up in the morning and thinking about, you know, is this why this didn't happen or whatever, you can also take it to other things like a woman being bald, maybe went through cancer and has no hair.
Sure.
You know, I'm so self-conscious. And you walk around with this kind of like veil over you, you know, and it's coming from inside. If you can just
forget about
the outside.
I think you're right. Obviously, you're continuing it because it's coming from inside. And
inside
I don't think that...
You.
Yeah, I'm not trying to justify it. I think that it's obviously you should let go of whatever burdens that you're imposing upon yourself.
But then again, it's
easy for me to say that because I'm not, you know, I've got the white privilege, I guess.
Well, is it privilege?
Yes.
Or is it just other people feeling bad because they're feeling bad? Stop feeling negative. Stop having negative thoughts. It is coming from within inside.
Well, hold on. I agree with you that you have far more control over you than you have over anything else in the world.
Other people, you're exactly right.
That's where the empowerment is. But I don't want to disempower somebody by not talking about what the truth is. And the truth is that people tend to get along with people that are like them. It's people with the same mannerisms, the same customs, the same dressing habits. Just ask anybody who's visited a foreign country for a long period of time, not just visited, I should say, who's lived in a foreign country. You know, there's just sort of differences. It's difficult to kind of get in there and say date or, get a job. Those kind of things, because you're competing against people that have, that they've been raised in an environment that they just understand these other folks and likes.
On that level, I will agree with you. Yes.
Judy, thanks for your call tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's get Aaron on the line. He's in Madison, Indiana. Aaron, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
I wanted to talk about the police shooting thing.
Sure.
First off, I want to talk about the gun that the kid was carrying. I mean, I've seen it in a couple of different publications like BBC. I've been around firearms my whole life. I own several. And looking at that gun, if somebody were to try to pull that on me or if I were to see that and somebody pointing that at somebody, it'd be very hard to distinguish otherwise that it wasn't a real weapon.
Yeah, that's if you were going to say anything different than that, I was going to call you out. That thing looks...
it definitely...
I mean, it looks kind of like a 1911, not perfectly, but I mean, it's close enough to a gun that it's a gun.
Right. Right. Well, I want to talk about the dispatch. The police released the dispatch, and the woman who had called, I'm not sure if it was a man or a woman, but the person that had called in the initial 911 call had told the operator that, you know, it's probably a gun. It's just a kid with a gun. But if you listen to the 911 operator actually dispatch the officers, all they say is that it's a call for a gun. Somebody's waving a gun around they don't distinguish, you know, it could be a toy gun.
Mm.
Now I want to defend the officers a little bit because I am a criminology major, and we do talk about, you know, we have talked a lot about this, and we know as a police officer, you know, when you're in that position and you do roll up on somebody who could have a gun and it's you and your partner, you know, your partner's life is kind of in your hands. It's just like being on a battlefield. You're responsible for your partner. And that split second of hesitation of, oh, is that, you know, really a gun? Is that a real gun? Could get you killed. It could get your partner killed. And police training, we talk a lot about police training, and I've done a lot of research about police training. The majority of departments train their police officers to shoot center mass in the chest.
Sure, that makes sense if you want to take somebody down. I'd like to talk about this partner thing because I think this is really important because this is truly what police officers, it's like a battlefield mentality. You're there protecting your buddy. And this is the God's honest truth. And I think that this is the way the man or the power structure or whatever it is uses feet on the ground, regular police officers who got the job because they wanted a good job and they wanted to be able to protect people. They use them to sort of perpetuate the violence inherent in the system. Because your buddy, your fellow officer, took a job where it is their job to take a bullet for me and for a civilian. You are the tip of the, you know, you're supposed to be the shield between me and violence. And when, you know, in that circumstance, I think, you know, first off, I question these officers pulling up on this person the way they did. Their tactics.
Yeah, that definitely could have been done differently. I totally agree with you there.
But when you pull a gun and you shoot somebody because you thought your buddy was going to be in danger, it makes you look good, but it really doesn't look good. That person was hired to protect me too.
No, actually, they don't have any obligation to protect you, but that's a whole other story. Aaron, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate it. I agree with Aaron's assessment that they approached it in the wrong manner. Whether that means that they should be held responsible for this death, I don't know. And I'm the first person to jump down the police's throat for misbehaving.
You sure are.
And in this case, I feel like, you know, this one might have been justified. Although, again, I think that they should have been more cautious in their approach, and then maybe everybody would have gotten to go home. 855-450-FREE. More coming up.
Do good people ever want to call an attorney just to find out if they're right or wrong? But every time you think about calling an attorney, what are you forced to think about first? Money. If you could call as often as you wanted and talk as long as you need without a bill, would you call? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio. Now at your fingertips.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101ReasonsFilm.com. 101ReasonsFilm.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If you're looking for work, you know what I mean by elevator speech. It's the short version, saying just enough to make the listener want to listen more. Even if you're not a job seeker, effective communication skills have never been more important, with money and attention so scarce now. So to cut through the clutter, choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Instead of saying, due to the fact that, say, because, and avoid mispronunciations. Say jewelry, not jewelry, which could offend. Undoubtedly, you don't want to say undoubtedly. And whatever you do, never use a preposition to end a sentence with. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are welcome to bring up anything you'd like. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
I don't care what color you are. You're going to need to deal with the government and filling out government paperwork. And there are lots of different pieces of paper that you're going to have, whether it's a patent, a will, a trademark, a living trust, LLC, divorce paperwork, immigration, bankruptcy. The list goes on and on. And really, it does. I'm holding in my hand a list of what has to be 24 different forms of paperwork that LegalZoom.com will help you fill out. Now, they're not attorneys, but they were started by an attorney. And they ask you questions and fill out common legal documents. Millions of people have trusted LegalZoom.com for their common legal documents, and you can too. Use coupon code FTL, that's FTL as in Free Talk Live, and save $10 on your order at LegalZoom.com. It helps us out and it helps you out. If you're running around without a will, you're just letting the state decide where your property goes. And it's not going to be the way you decided. It's LegalZoom.com. Coupon code FTL. I filled out my will there, and it was fast and easy. LegalZoom.com.
Police shootings, white privilege, whatever you want to discuss, you dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. Moses is on with us in Tallahassee, listening to WVFT. Hey, Moses.
Hi. Hey. Good evening.
Welcome, sir.
Yes, I wanted to change the topic, but since this might be my chance to chime in on the current issue.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I haven't watched television since 2008. I just listen to talk radio, and periodically I go to the library and get on the internet. But I heard one of the panel mention that Officer Darren Wilson, I think that's his name, is about the same height and the same weight that
Michael Brown.
Mike Brown is.
Yeah, that was something I read on the internet, that he was like 10 pounds lighter.
10 pounds lighter. I mean, even though the guy struggled and they had this ensuing in the car and he got shot, he reached for the police gun, which is seems to be insane. But still, when he ran away, he was unarmed. And like you said, both of them being comparatively the same height and weight. I don't know why the police claim to be so cowardly. A coward and claiming that this man is Hulk, you know, when they, you know. I mean, what other type of training do police officers have besides, you know, the gun? I mean, going to the gun range.
Well, they have training on hand. I mean, some level of combat, close quarter combat.
They also have training on when to use a weapon. And I really question many shootings that go on in cities. When you're talking about the situation, Michael Brown was walking down a residential street. People lived in houses along the side of this. When you start pulling out a gun and shooting six times on a street, the bullets that don't, even the bullets that do go into people, they come out the other side and they go places. And this is a really dangerous aspect to, you know, the it's the other side that's never talked about when it's talked about officer safety.
Okay. Again, did he have any other type of deterrent, like a taser or some, you know?
The story that I had heard, and I only heard it because I was listening to Peace or Cop Block Radio this week with Derek J. Freeman. They were actually reading the interview. So when the police were interviewing Darren Wilson, they actually read that the text of that interview on the air. And according to the officer, he claimed that he did have some sort of non-lethal thing in his behind him, but he was sitting in his car, I guess, at the time when he claims he was initially attacked. And so he said that he could not reach for that at that time. So the claim was that he did have it, but could not access it.
And it's also really difficult to know what happened, right? Like there's the testimony of the officer, and that's all the testimony we've got because Mike Brown's dead. And there's no video camera. Many police departments have cameras that officers wear, but Ferguson
not
doesn't.
That many.
And well, many do. And, but you know, many more should, because we should have an audio and video account of The claim is that officers are our employees. We should have an audio video account of what our employees are doing on a day-to-day basis when they interact with the public, because you never know who's a criminal and who isn't. If they're not a criminal, you're supposed to be protecting and serving them. And at this point, there was a study that just came out in Utah that the second deadliest person, besides a person that lives with you in your house, the most deadly person to you is your intimate partner. Your husband or wife is most likely to kill you. Second most deadly, a police officer in the state of Utah.
Hey, Moses, thanks for the call, man. I appreciate it. Call in if you had the other issue, whatever it was. Call in any other night. We'd be happy to talk to you, but we got to get some other folks on here, like Jerry, listening in Battle Creek to WBCK FM. Hey, Jerry.
Hi, how you doing?
Welcome, sir.
Bear with me for just a minute here. I want to talk about the white privilege, but I need to give you a little background.
Okay.
I'm a mid-60s white guy. Who grew up in a poor family in Detroit, and you know, worked my way to go to school, worked in construction with mostly black guys when I was 16, 17, 18 years old. During 1967 summer, I was working a few blocks away from the Detroit riots where we heard gunshots going off as we continued to work because I needed the money. And with black guys, by the way, we were working together, wondering why all these other busloads of people are getting taken to jail. At a time when there really was extreme racism in the country. Fast forward, I go to college. I partly got to college through sports and mostly hung around with the black guys. Get out of college, go on to graduate school, worked through two graduate degrees, graduated with a doctorate in 1980, and out looking for jobs and numerous jobs, high-level administrative positions at universities, considered for, and every time was told directly to my face after 2 days of interviews in each case, "We didn't hire you because you weren't either black or female." And I know some of you said, "Well, that was mandated by the law, so that feels less hurtful." I'll tell you, it doesn't feel less hurtful, especially after you put in 30 years of your life to get to a certain point.
No, that's institutionalized racism and sexism. That's precisely what that is, or at least racial and sexual bias.
Okay, so I'm still fast forward here. Now, so at that point, I'm really angry, and I decided not to continue that. I went to my own business. Okay, I was very angry. At one point, after a couple of years of being very angry, I realized something that one of the black guys I worked in construction with told me. He was in his 60s when I was 18. I remember one day he was being treated really badly, and I thought it was because he was black. And I said to him, "Bill, what's going on? Aren't you upset by that?" And he said, "You know what? If I worry about that too much, it's only hurting me. Mm-hmm. It's not going to hurt him." And that came to me when I'm, 32 years old or 33 years old. And I realized, that's what I'm doing to myself. Okay, now fast forward to today. Here's what I see the difference in the racism today. Back then, when the guy I worked with, Bill, had a reason to blame most of his discrimination or the way he was treated on racism, he didn't. Today, and I'll say one of you guys said, "Well, people have experienced that." I think some people haven't experienced it, but they've been told every time you're not treated well, it's because it's racist.
Mm. Right. And I don't know. Right? It's like it's country. Paranoia if you're wrong, and it's just the truth if you're right. And this is the difficulty is that I wonder what the benefit is to you, the individual.
Benefit of what?
The benefit of,
second guessing?
The phantoms. Yeah, the second guessing, blaming it on this, that, or the other. Because there are lots of successful black people to point to, and I don't think that they got where they were by saying, "Hey, I'm being discriminated against. Somebody cut me a break."
Yeah, can I say one quick thing related to that? You're absolutely right. There's a fine line between it's actual racism and I'm imagining it as racist. Now you got to realize my doctorate's in psychology. That's what I got it in. So I do a lot of analysis of this type of stuff. And I really see a lot of people now, I don't want anybody to believe, because I'm a real defender of minority groups and everybody should be treated equally. Mm-hmm. But the problems now compared to when I was 12 and there were black neighborhoods that people couldn't leave their neighborhood at night. And I remember that as a 12-year-old. When it was really bad to today, and yes, there are still problems today, but now people jump on, "You only did that because I was black. You only did that because I was a woman. You only did that because..."
People do.
No,
Jerry,
maybe
it's an interesting...
Because you're being a jerk.
You made some interesting points tonight. Thank you for the call tonight. I definitely like the point about... any amount of time you spend worrying is just a waste of your brain cycles. 855-450-FREE. Stay positive. And, I understand that can be difficult in some circumstances. There's more coming up, but it's worth it. It's worth the effort, in my opinion. More coming up on Free Talk Live. You take control.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
On Facebook, on the news, and in conversations with friends, we're bombarded every day with advice on how to be healthier, from gluten-free and non-GMO diets to how much exercise and sleep the body needs. But how much have you heard about alkalizing the body? AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops are a holistic and natural way to get your body's pH levels back in balance. Just a few drops in water will help your body rid itself of harmful waste, and even the healthiest of diets can be complemented with your daily use of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Who isn't looking for more vibrance, vigor, and energy? Now buy two bottles of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops and get $10 off your order. Visit AlkaVision.com or call 800-518-7615. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops are packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds. Open the door to greater health, vitality, and zest for life. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health. Call 800-518-7615 or head to AlkaVision.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Moments remain here. If you are already on the line, there's a good chance you're going to get on here tonight. But if you don't make it in, because this is the final segment for our live Saturday edition, if you don't make it in tonight, no worries. We do a live Sunday show, and Mark, you and I will both be here for it.
Yeah.
We'll be joined by special guest co-host Dale Everett
from From Flaming Freedom.
He was the host of Flaming Freedom, and I don't know if he ever will be again. The show's currently off the air, but okay. It was a darn good show when it lasted. He was a regular co-host on Free Talk Live in the past, so he'll be joining us tomorrow night, and of course, the phones will be open as always, so feel free to dial us up any night of the week, because we do it live 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time. If we are not heard on your local radio station all 7 nights, maybe you're getting 1 night or 2 nights, give a call to the local program director this week during business hours and talk to him or her and let them know that you really appreciate Free Talk Live and you'd like to hear some more of it. We sure would appreciate you doing that. To those of you listening through other means, podcast or online streaming, if you want to support the show, great way to do it is to become a Free Talk Live amplifier. You go to amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. Simple idea. You send $5 a month into Free Talk Live, comes out of your credit card, you don't have to think about it, or your PayPal account. You just sign up and then you don't have to think about it from that point forward, and we'll take that money and invest it into Free Talk Live, getting on more radio stations. We're on over 150 stations today. We can have 300, 400, 500. It's all possible, but it takes money to market the show, and then also getting on more people's internet connections and more podcast listeners and things like that. We can make that happen, but we need your support, and we really appreciate it. So please go to amp.freetalklive.com. If you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live and you want us to continue doing it and continue getting more new listeners to understand the ideas of freedom, then please, amp.freetalklive.com. You get perks too, like access to the AMP-only Facebook group, AMP-only phone lines, forum, and more. Go to amp.freetalklive.com as we go to the phones and the fun. Tom's in Baltimore. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tom.
Hi, gentlemen. I wanted to point out the conversation has taken an interesting turn and pointing out really something that is self-evident when you really think about it, and that is when you spend too much time, like your previous caller, Rakia, I think her name was, worrying about what you should feel each morning when you wake up. She uses the collective term we. She uses the word feel a lot. Again, these things aren't necessarily based in fact. I know that these racial privilege doors swing in favor of the opposite of whatever race you may be from time to time. I'm a white guy, and I've had to dodge that racial privilege door just trying to get out so it didn't hit me in the rear end on the way out. And it does swing both ways. But if you spend too much time on wondering, worrying, being concerned about how that door is swinging, because let's face it, it's cliche, but life is not fair. And whether it's a black or white issue, green or brown, fat or skinny, there's always going to be an element of something being unfair that you're going to feel wronged about in one way, shape, or form. But when you spend too much time on, I think you both agree, at least from your comments earlier, it seems that you do, you end up kind of stuck in a paradigm where you're just not getting out of what turns into a revolving door. And you're battling these concerns, and you're really not forwarding yourself. She did make one good point. She said, you know, we feel that we have to be better and more qualified. You know what? We all can be and should be looking forward to being better and more qualified at whatever we endeavor.
She did seem, I mean, despite her claim that she was getting up in the morning and thinking about these things during the day, she did seem to have a very positive mentality, and I think that's certainly a good thing, and I agree with your comments generally. Tom, thanks for the call tonight. Let's continue here.
A positive attitude is far more powerful than the color of your skin.
Yeah, no doubt. David is in Panama City listening to WYOO. Hey, David.
Hey, guys. The one thing that I really want to touch on is that, yes, there is a racial divide, and there's racism on both in every different culture, mm-hmm. I mean, towards one another. And I've been, I mean, well, let's just put it this way. I'm Polish and Jewish.
Got a few troubles.
Figure that one out. Okay. and the thing is that when is it ever going to come to a point to where we all do get along and we don't post-judge each other or prejudge each other?
I think it's going to be when races become – when everybody's so so much of a mixed mutt that it just doesn't mm-hmm. exist anymore.
It's going to be a long while.
Yeah, it's going to be a long while. Things are different than they are now. Mixed couples can walk around in America. Is it post-racial? I don't think it is. But I think that we're moving in that direction.
I think it's moving in the right direction.
And to harp on it many times, I'm not saying you should shut up, that people should shut up, but I think to harp on it in a negative way it makes people feel set upon.
It doesn't move it forward.
Right. I don't think it moves the ball forward.
Because with Ferguson and everything, now every police officer in this nation has got a target on them.
Well, what do you mean a target?
And
do you think that they're going to get shot?
I do believe that will possibly happen.
You know that it's one of the top, it's not in the top 10 most dangerous jobs in America? Loggers and fishermen, these are far more dangerous jobs?
Well, and they're all not carrying a weapon either, and you ain't got people concealing a weapon wanting to kill a cop.
Considering how awful the police have been to people over the last few decades and how violent they are, Ferguson is certainly, not necessarily going to spark what it is that you're afraid of. There have been more horrible stories than what happened in Ferguson. I mean, accounts of police shooting children, throwing tear gas grenades or explosive devices into cribs with babies in them. I mean, there's all kinds of justification.
If you want to wage war on somebody, the police are a poor people to choose.
Hey, David, thanks for the call tonight. I wish we had more time to talk about that, but we don't because I want to get Rick on the line in Indianapolis listening to WIBC. Rick, you're on the air.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Good, sir. Go ahead.
Hey, just want to talk about the kid up in Cleveland.
Sure.
Again, real quick. I grew up over here on the west side of Indianapolis, kind of in a more rural area, I guess. So I grew up with guns. I had a BB gun when I was 5.
Wow, that is young. A BB gun when you were 5?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, shotgun when I was 7. I'd go hunting with my dad, like that.
But he wouldn't let you handle them on your own. He would be like, this is your gun, and you can use it when we go.
Absolutely,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So,
I'm just trying, as a father, I'm trying to figure out when my son should be able to get a BB gun, and 5 ain't then. I can tell you that.
Yeah. Yeah. So, and there's a whole bunch of anecdotal stories, when we were kids with the BB guns and whatnot. But one thing that always stuck with me with my dad was that he always taught us to respect weapons. It didn't matter if it was a knife. It didn't matter if it was a gun. Even hands, you have to respect weapons because they have the power to seriously hurt somebody that you care about or, just in general, just somebody to hurt. So I guess I would go more towards parenting with this child up in Cleveland. I mean, what was his parents doing? I mean, did his parents know he was at the park with a BB gun?
Well, hold on. I grew up with a BB gun, too, but we played guns over at my friend's house, which was in a neighborhood, and we'd run around, and we had, things that by today's standards look remarkably like guns. I had a little bullpup cap gun that, unless you looked down the barrel of it, you wouldn't have been able to tell that it wasn't a gun. I mean, it was really realistic, and we'd point those things and shoot each other. Maybe if one of the parents came out of the house, if we're feeling froggy, we might aim it at them and go, pow, pow, you're dead or whatever.
But then again, wouldn't you also, didn't your dad also teach you, hey, this is a weapon?
Yeah, with a gun.
Wouldn't common sense kind of come into play if the cops are coming here, am I really going to reach for my BB gun?
I don't know if this kid was thinking that he was going to pull the gun out and lay it on the ground or give it to the officer or whatever they were thinking. Now, let's not forget to hear that we should not be laying the blame of what should have been done at the feet of a 12-year-old when we have a 27-year-old trained officer to look at here. I mean, where are these police officers pulling up and that sort of thing? They're the ones who are charged to serve and protect this young man. They would call them a child. I wouldn't call a 12-year-old a child. I believe at 12 years old, you're entering manhood.
Rick, I appreciate your call tonight, man. Thanks for making it. Let's get Eric in here real quick, also in Indy, listening to WIBC. Eric, go ahead. We're real short on time.
I'll be fast. I'm black, in full disclosure. And
would you stop that?
Just full disclosure. But it's interesting, how we look at the Jewish community, and 60 years ago, they were, in these Stockholm and in these concentration camps, we never ever would say to a Jewish person to forget being, your ancestors being in concentration camps and all that. But we're talking about a systemic over 300 and odd years in this country of race, of blacks being subjugated. And less than 60 years ago, when the Jewish, you don't want the Jewish to forget, but less than 60 years ago, we passed the Civil Rights Act. Now we're supposed to forget about it 50 years later. When are we supposed to bring it up, number one?
Excellent.
Number two,
Eric, yes, call us another night.
I totally want to have this conversation. We've got 5 seconds.
Out of time.
FreeTalkLive.com.
You've heard Free Talk Live.
The amount of young people being brought up on criminal charges, sex offender charges, for taking nude photos of themselves and putting them online. It's just so sad to see these people having their lives just rolled right over the top of by these prosecutors that want to make it look like they're doing something good, but they're not doing anything that's helping anyone. There's no victim in this case. When you hear the term child pornography, what should come to mind, if anything, should be the idea of forcing children into sexual scenes and videotaping or photographing
adults
them.
Adults forcing children or somebody...
Even if it's a child forcing another child, I think the force is the issue there. If you're talking about a 15-year-old girl voluntarily choosing to take a nude photo of herself to send to her boyfriend or to post online, no one forced her to do that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's free.